A.
How much of all your happiness can I really claim? I made a deal of you, yeah, but weren't you worth the flame?
Operation Experiment. This is Operation Experiment. These men arrive here on X Day minus 60. It has taken them the full 2 months to get ready. Today is X Day. It is now HR minus 59 minutes. There is less than an hour left. There can be no margin for error. There can be no second chance.
Well, good hello, everyone. This is not Barb Golden and Crack of Dawn, who is usually here the first Thursday of every month at midnight. Ouch. And it is I, the over-the-edge guy. Izzy isn't. But it's not quite over-the-edge either. It's a special, unscheduled broadcast of Over the Edge and the Subgenius. The Church of the Subgenius Foundation Incorporated are all here, and we're all going to do 5 hours together, all together, right here, all on KPFA. And that's what we're doing. So it's not this and it's not that, it's both. Gentlemen, ready for testing. Put on your headphones and pick up a microphone.
Bob.
I love Bob.
That's Ed Horn of the Church of the Subgenius.
I have decided unilaterally to name this show.
Unibilaterally?
To title this show the New Year's Revolution Show. Now, what does that mean?
That means we have to spin around in a Gregorian manner.
Well, according to my script, it will be explained later on.
So that
Okay. I don't know.
Cuatro. I don't know how to control this thing or anything else.
Where is Dr. Hal?
Dr. Hal, we buried him, I think, last week.
Ladies and gentlemen, we regret to inform you that Dr. Hal has passed away almost a week ago today, and he will no longer grace the big fat chairs of the Subgenius.
Well, actually, we did bring him in because he wasn't smelling that bad since it's been very cold outside lately, so we got that cold snap.
Oh,
so,
I see him, yes.
So, yeah, so we just propped him in the thing, and because he's such a motor mouth,
I like that.
He's still talking.
I mean, I like it.
We just have to push the microphone real close. We're trying to get a microphone jack just right into his jaw.
I like the glazed look.
Yeah, uh-huh. So yeah, we can squeeze another show out of Dr. Hal. His cooling carcass.
Yeah, just a few electrical shocks. Apply a few electrical shocks, and there'll be an automatic reaction, in his case, talking.
That's right. And Gabrofram is here with his jumper cables of love.
What happened to... Where's Bug Girl?
Where's Bug Girl?
Oh, no. Bug Girl is not coming, is she?
Not till she sees you, Don.
It's my understanding that Reverend Stang, the iconic sacred scribe of the Church of the Subgenius, will be here.
He's listening, frustrated.
And he's warm and he stinks.
He's wishing.
You know, with Reverend Stang, a wish becomes reality.
Very quickly,
very easily, because he has so much slack.
He has three pairs at the cleaners.
He has so many slacks.
In Cleveland.
There we go.
Is he still in Cleveland?
Yes.
Oh.
Okay.
Why? Why is anybody still in Cleveland?
I understand it's the most violent city in America.
Really?
Yeah, but see, the reason is that the Reverend Stang is there. He sucks all the slack from everybody else. And there's an umbrella piece around it. But everybody else, in consequence, you know, stresses up and they begin to throttle one another.
Well, there it is. Slack sucker. He's a slack sucker. Okay, well, so
we're really funny now.
All right, right now, okay. Bishop Joey's here, and he's answering any of your religious and/or sexual questions. So you can call in at 848. That's all. That's all the only numbers we got. We had a big budget cut here at KPFA, so we had to lose four of our phone numbers. So we're just down to 848. Just dial 848 and wait.
And John Shirley is here to answer any of your science fiction questions.
All right.
The sexual and religious
How big was Paul Anderson's pole?
And was Philip really a dick?
It's one of the mysteries. Religion and sexuality have converged it has dropped its pants this year because of Haggard, right? And people like that.
Haggard.
I mean, so my question to you is,
yes.
Where is your particular theological domain with respect to this emerging explosion of self-exposure sexually amongst the religious leaders of our country?
It's under my bed. The domain is under my bed.
I feel there is no God.
You feel, but
yeah,
I
exactly.
feel, but to feel is not enough to be
really
expressively, intellectually, and convincingly appropriate.
I mean, feelings
are no longer shorthand for your expression of a religious and/or sexual congress. which is the 110th time I've been going around.
Well, one of my samples says, feeling is believing.
Feeling is believing.
Dr. Johnson said, I refute it thus, and he kicked a stone thus. And he hurt his foot, and then he said, I believe, because that hurts.
That's too much of a coincidence for comfort, sir.
I know, but you can't expect anything less here on KPFA, 94.1, in your ear. You're trying to go to bed, you're trying to go to sleep, and somebody's left the radio on, and you reach for the dial, and it won't turn off, and your radio's stuck at 94.1. And the clock is ticking, and you're trying to get some sleep because tomorrow you got to get up and face another day at your grueling, grim, boring job. But here you are, stuck listening to the radio, listening to us. So don't join us. Join us at 848.
And if it hurts, you believe.
If it hurts, believe.
If it hurts, you believe.
Believe. Yes, I have a sexual question. I have a cat, a female cat, and she eats too much. And the reason she eats too much is because she likes to fight all the other cats in the neighborhood.
And this is a sexual question. That's what worries me.
And
here.
And
he's listening to his delayed broadcast. He wants to hear himself.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Yeah, the whole station now, you know, is on a delay. Didn't used to be, but it is now.
What? So we can't say beep or
beep or beep or beep.
We have a dump button, but I promise not to use it.
Oh, wow. Well, we did, yeah.
So when you call...
Yeah.
Listen to me, people. When you call, don't listen to your radio.
Don't listen to your computer. Listen to your telephone. Listen to your
because
telephone.
In your telephone's earpiece is
listen
the only
me.
Real time
listen to me.
That exists now.
Listen to me only.
Turn down your radio. Turn down your computer.
Turn up
you
your radio.
If you try to converse with us with those up,
throw
you
your
will sound drunk.
Throw away your computer.
You will sound drunk if you attempt to follow the delayed broadcast.
Drink heavily.
Thank you.
Please don't speak into the microphones.
That's too much of a coincidence.
Think into the microphones. Only think into them. These microphones are so sensitive that they feel insulted if you talk into them.
We're stinking into the microphone right now is Dr. Hal. We're trying to get Dr. Hal jacked into the microphone.
I just want to get this over the early, you know, the Stang and the
Let's
Hal.
Let's try to get the show
they don't exist
out of the door by 12:30.
And Phineas Narco's a tape.
He's loopy. He's loopy. Phineas is loopy. Looped.
Yes, this surprised me. I thought Phineas Narco was Jane.
Nothing. But there's no doubt that someone's passing out information.
And that information is the number you can call to find out about this coming St. Stupid's Day Parade, number 29.
Yeah, it's coming right up.
That's right. April 1st will be the 29th annual St. Stupid's Day Parade, starting at noon at the Pointy Building in San Francisco, going up Columbus Avenue to either Washington Square Park or Joe DiMaggio's bathroom. So get ready, put it in your calendar, and be prepared to march once again in honor of St. Stupid, a little-known St. 442, 443, patrons, and civilizations, and parking meters. I bet you didn't know that. You didn't. That Catholic, are you? I didn't think so.
That's April 1st.
Is that April 1st?
I mean, is that, that when the parade is? April. I thought it was April 1st.
Yeah. It could be April 1st. I'm not sure. Noon at the Pointy Building. So if you want more information about that, go to saintstupid.com. It's S-A-I-N-T-S-T-U-P-I. S-T-U-P-I. Whatever. Figure it out. Google it. Google it yourself. Oh, yeah? Well, Google this.
What?
Flying saucer detected and registered.
And now the pretty part of the show.
Computation center,
Pantera. That's so much better. Now maybe you can get to sleep, because we'll be playing some easy listening trance music for you to get into your theta state. That's right.
Trained parroting puppet assassins in maximum security insanity prison. So fighting these undetectable extermination eye, Francis.
It's the face of the new fascism. It's the face of the new fascism. It's soothing fascism. The soothing sounds of fascism tonight.
Deadly worldwide conspiratorial gangster computer god communism.
Try that number.
Call that number. Data follows. Distance 486 miles. Height 50.2 miles. Speed 5 miles per second.
Something bad has happened.
The show, you mean.
So you can't use all those recorded instructions on phone fidelity. Those are all gone now, right?
Frozen. Wow. Say a good day. Cool.
That is correct.
Good day.
You could technically still have phone fidelity.
Yeah. I now have recreation over.
The delay doesn't really affect that. It's just that if you don't listen to your telephone, you won't hear yourself.
Okay, take a six-pack of cans.
Estimated time of arrival at contact point, 1 minute 58 seconds.
Yes, dear friend. Okay. Now, that usually brings Stang if you say, yes, dear friend. It evokes him. It invokes him. It summons him. The Reverend Stang will be here later. The Reverend Stang of the Church of the Subgenius.
Stop it, Gary.
I'm hearing
and co-creator of the Church of the Subgenius, Philo Drummond.
Jack.
Right old trumpet.
Right old trumpet.
Right old trumpet.
Right old trumpet is his goyle.
He's a dry old trumpet. He's been pumped dry for the last time.
He's a crusty old
pumpet.
He's a crusty old
stump.
He's the Karl Rove of the Church of the Subgenius.
Now,
58, right. Let fire control.
Fire control alerted, sir.
Two grains of sand fall out now and then.
Young Marsnitz also says that he saw something on the moors.
On a quiet summer day in Houston, Texas, unbeknownst to the rest of the world, a great scientific operation was performed.
A squid was eating dough in a polyethylene bag.
On that day, a human being was given a shape that would last forever.
A very repellent shape.
When may we expect you?
In 30 seconds.
A shape that would never age or decay.
Over and off.
And an event had taken place that is soon to affect all of humanity.
Something that he insists was his brother. But we know that his brother is dead. We also know that he is not lying in his coffin. Someone in this village is practicing witchcraft.
The Reverend Stang will be here. Have faith.
You want to play it?
Yeah, this is not your usual camp followers meeting here.
Yeah, Ed's going to try to play it now.
We've got the big wig himself here coming tonight.
Oh, he's doing really good.
Mr. Ivan Stang, owner and operator of the Subgenius Church Foundation of America.
But Ed and I will be gone by the time Stang gets here.
You guys were gone years ago.
So why are we here? Why did we drive all the way from our far-off homes and nice warm
probably
beds?
Probably dating from the acid tests.
For the New Year's Revolution show.
Oh, that's right.
Come on, get into it.
But what if I refuse to even participate in the new year?
We have a whole new chance here.
You know, this is the last year. You have to understand that it has been announced. The Church of the Subgenius has announced that the end of the world will take place on Thursday, July 5th, 2007. And preparation for the fulfillment of this doomsday prophecy, the church is requesting that all of its members participate in a festival with rock concerts and blasphemous rituals taking place in upstate New York during the final weekend before the arrival
of the apocalypse. Oh, they're always doing that.
They do that every year. But see, there are many other people who make predictions about the end of the world. They give up too easily.
Huh.
They say the end of the world. There was a guy in 1986 or so who wrote a book explaining that the end of the world would come in 1988, and he sold 5 million of them, and it didn't come, and so he wrote another book saying it would come in 1989. He sold a lot of those too. He was that much persistent, and then he gave up. The Church of the Subgenius never gives up predicting the end of the world.
Even after the end of the world, the Subgenius will predict it.
Well, if you go to the edge of the universe, and throw a rock, what do you hit? So after the end of the world, you know, there's got to be another end, another end,
and
another end.
Well, there's the Gardal Shield. First of all, no one ever accounts for the Gardal Shield.
And there's a novel by John Shirley called The Other End, but I won't promote it this segment.
The Other End?
The Other End.
What's that, the
it's
check?
It's my alternative apocalypse.
What?
Novel of alternative apocalypse.
We're all here.
You know, every time I look for a John Shirley book at my local bookstore, I don't see one.
Well, you got to look in the cheesy section of the cheesy paperback section.
Gosh,
or go to a better bookstore. A better class of bookstore might help also.
And I look for those books by Lloyd St. Alcorn. I don't know if you remember those.
Oh, that's a name that resonates in the...
Dr. David Meyer, I believe, wrote several terrible books under the pen name of Lloyd St. Alcorn.
But it was slack because he got paid to write terrible books.
That's right. And he got paid lousy money.
I get paid lousy money to write good books. So he had more slack than me because he got paid the same money to write bad books, which is easier. Edgar Wisenant made himself a nice packet of money with a book assuring everyone that 1988 was the end of the world. He had 88 reasons for his assurance. And he sold 4 million copies to a gullible public. And in 1989, came out with a book in which he said he had made some mistakes, but it was going to end in 1989. You know, that kind of persistence is admirable. Elizabeth Clare Prophet said that 1990 was going to be the end of the year. The Gulf War broke out, and religious enthusiasts got on their phones to the radio station saying that Armageddon would be in 1991.
Oh, well, everybody I know died in 2007.
Could you kind of amend
you're mixing up the past and the future again. See, you know, that Gary's problem is that he thinks that the future is the past because he lives outside of time. Gary lives in eternity. He's got 1 foot in eternity, and he keeps wobbling back and forth, and he kind of gets them mixed up. And he can see the future. He thinks it's the past. He spins around. He doesn't know the difference.
But spending all this time in my own tent made out of my own skin, wouldn't you think that I would be in my own reality?
Too soon for what?
Absolutely. You're spinning. You're like an object being spun on a lathe and gradually ground down into a shape that can only be imagined.
Here I have a question for you, John. This is more KPFA-like.
More time for
and
what?
I found this here on the floor of KPFA. I can't
believe
it.
That's where all my questions come from.
It says, what are the ties between immigrants from a Middle Eastern country and an African American born in South Carolina?
Is that a reference to Obama or something?
I have no idea.
The end of the world's coming, and you're just talking about this stuff.
Question two, Don.
On the floor here. That's how desperate we are for questions from the great world. We're scrabbling around on the floor like a crack addict.
Good. You want questions? You got questions. Why can't you amend your revelation and move it up to early September?
Followers of Nostradamus claim that, according to the French seer, the end of the world came in July 1999.
we're perfectly willing to adjust to circumstances. Hey, can we have September 11th early this year?
The supreme moment of the universe has already happened.
That is a grim joke. Jesus said this generation should not pass away until the fulfillment of his prediction of the end times was fulfilled. And I don't know if anybody noticed 1,998 or so years ago that it didn't come about. So all these people predict the end of the world. It doesn't happen. The Church of the Subgenius predicts it much more diligently than everybody else.
June 7th, 89 is when it really happens on 1:23:45 a.m. Universal Time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We lived through it. I have it on tape. It really happened. I'm honest.
Gary, your output in the amp is a bit high for that mic.
Okay. That's because Ed's playing it now. See, no hands, and it's still loud.
I've got a list at the end of the world.
Play something really loud.
If you couldn't
play something really loud.
Yeah. St. Augustine said it was coming in the year 1000.
That's it? That's as loud as you'll ever get?
No, we can play as loud as you want.
That's pretty good there, I think.
Pretty good right there?
Yeah.
Okay, go to it, Ed. It's your turn to...
Isaac Newton predicted the end of the world.
It's just spiking up to the top.
1733 for the end of the world.
Oh, Isaac Newton predicted the end of the show.
Isaac Newton said someday puzzling show would end and everyone would rejoice in the end.
And the Wellman head fell from the tree and hit Isaac square in the caputer. Oh,
he
yeah.
did, and Isaac Newton predicted the end of the world for 1733.
If you would like to attempt to speak to the Subgenius Foundation Church of America, please call us at 510-848-4425. 510-848-4425. Don't say hello when your phone stops ringing. You're on the air, and don't listen to your radio, please.
In 1736, William Whiston of Cambridge announced that the end of the world was about to commence. Panic-stricken Londoners headed for high places to escape the floods, he predicted. None of them came.
Didn't anybody ask, how does he know?
Emanuel Swedenborg, who conversed frequently with angels, was certain that 1757 was the date.
Our city.
Oh, hey, that reminds me. We're supposed to have Swedenborg bread for dinner tonight.
Is that like sweet bread?
We cut the pancreas out of philosophers and dip them in cornmeal. They're delicious.
The thyroid is supposed to be especially delectable if you get a mathematician.
Nietzsche's is real bitter, though. You don't like bitter, you like Nietzsche.
Oh, everyone has their own little Nietzsche these days.
Yeah. So if you want to join in on a frivolity and a clever wordplay, just dial 8484425 and you're on the air. Come on, you can do it.
I think that they were trying to say a Freud to live and too young to die.
But there are people around the world who really still believe that if you eat somebody's heart who's courageous, you will be courageous. So if you eat their brains...
Eat somebody prettier than you are. Eat somebody smarter than you are. Eat somebody stronger than you are.
Well, I've been nibbling a lot.
But eat somebody.
I've been nibbling.
Whatever you do.
Trying to not
bite. Are we allowed to say that on the air? Eat somebody?
Yeah, if it's a song. You gotta eat
somebody on your bond. You gotta eat somebody on your bond. But not their lungs.
Got any recipes? So cannibalism's coming back, we hear. So if you got some recipes...
It will come back when the world famine comes, my friend, which I have been predicting. The American famine.
The great culling begins.
Imagine a famine in the United States. What would that be like?
Well, yum.
Who would we eat first?
Well, we'd eat the Welsh rabbits made from Volkswagens.
Okay. There are people who've eaten cars.
Yeah.
There are, bit by bit, like chunk by chunk. There was a guy who cut up a car and ate it. It took him several years.
Did you ever see the methane bird?
Through him.
the cartoon, the metal-eating bird? You've seen it, haven't you?
No.
No. I don't watch television.
Well, Doug Wellman has seen the metal-eating bird.
Yeah. Oh, wait, whip it out. You got it on tape? Whip it out. But
Russell.
Charles Russell, founder of a group later known as the Witnesses of Jehovah, does that sound familiar, said that Christ...
Oh, yeah, they had a big
he
hit.
Said that Christ had returned invisibly in the year 1874. There was no way of proving he was wrong.
Oh, well, look, but the girls all knew that somebody was staring at them in their gym locker room.
Yeah, when they went wee-wee, there was the guy with a beard.
But, you know, in fact, somebody pointed out to me today that if Jesus is always watching you, we are Jesus' porn.
Oh, man.
Oh, that's Jesus. Right.
That's disturbing.
We're going to porn with Jesus watch.
Yes, and we're Bob.
Well, Russell, what is your definition of
fanaticism? That's what your relatives do in heaven.
So where are all the rest of all
those
the
relatives
important
are right,
guests
yes.
on this show?
There, I think it is something. Look behind the prop bush.
Yes.
They're just lazy. They think 5 hours, no hurry. Little do they know how much of a hurry we're in here.
We've got to get 5 hours cranked out here in 20 minutes.
They've been verbally arrested, I suspect.
They're listening to the...
Hey, that's going to drive me home in a minute.
I'm just going to drop. I'm going to drop you up in Pescadero, because I'm going to be in Pescadero all weekend. So if you can find Bishop Joey in Pescadero this weekend, you'll win the prize.
Are we straying from all of the slack?
I'm just going to rent Bishop Joey and ride him on the beach out at San Gregorio myself.
Rent the Bishop Joey. Yeah?
The Jehovah's Witnesses predicted the end of the world for 1975. When they come to your door and they're trying to convince you they've got some inside information.
Was the last
1975. Then again, 1984. They said that was going to be the end of the world. When they come to your house... Ask them if they remember that. And if you want an alternative apocalypse, go to www.signsofwitness.com, where is my website of alternative apocalypse.
Hangman rope. Apocalypse?
Apocalypse is related to apocalypse. It's when you can't say apocalypse, and so you say apocalypse.
I've had a little experience with the pucker lips.
Well, apocalypse only happens back east. They don't have
apocalypse now.
Yeah, they have sodas here, and they have pop back there.
So. Pop my lips now. A pucker lips now.
Support lips now.
Now, this is a true thing. In 1983, as the residents of Calcata, a small town 30 miles north of Rome, prepared for their annual procession honoring a holy relic, a shocking announcement from the parish priest put a damper on festivities. The relic has vanished. What was that relic? The lopped off body parts of a certain... Messiah, that is, it was the foreskin of Jesus. It was alleged to be, I'm not making this up, the foreskin of Jesus supposedly found in India, in Calcutta, not Calcutta, in 1557. And a series of miracles soon followed finding the holy foreskin.
Doesn't it miraculously
storm, perfumed mist,
every year?
Well, in fact, it has not turned up, and the people of Calcutta claim that it was stolen by the Vatican,
holy
who didn't
foreskin.
Like the holy foreskin being out there
holy
in their church,
foreskin.
And they were embarrassed by it.
They were afraid someone was going to clone
okay.
it.
Like,
that there has been discussion
will.
Of cloning the holy
okay,
foreskin.
So you go first.
Sounds like a Bill Henry.
Okay. Here, I've got mine here in my wallet. Let's try to clone it and see if it works for me. I'm Jewish.
Lines of pilgrims stretch from the church doors to beyond the walls of the fortress town to see the holy foreskin.
I think we should stretch Bishop Joey's over this African drum head.
Oh.
He used it as a shower cap.
Oh. The Pope is using it as a cap, and it makes that weird hat more snuggly.
The skateboarders want
to
wear it.
There's an image
too.
To conjure for you, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, if you can join in here in the blasphemy, we got blasphemy, 49 cents a pound. It's available right now here on your radio, so call 848-4425 and contribute your blasphemy right here.
famous religious figures in America who were anti-gay were turned out to be gay this year. Haggard and another guy. His name
really
I forgot.
Sure.
Merle?
I don't really know.
No, not Merle. Merle, did not. Merle is the last guy to turn out to be gay, I hope. You're going to ruin my,
sure,
my, you know, my reverence.
Sorry,
for, I'm down with gays, but, oh, but I don't want Merle to be gay. Merle Haggard may not be gay.
Merle's into truckers, I hear. Mother truckers.
But what I want to know is, when is the Bishop Joey going to come out?
Bishop Joey did come out. He came out last year and got all wet, so he went back in.
It's going to be winter for another six
years. Well, ladies and gentlemen, he has arrived. There's no point in putting it off anymore. He is in the building.
The Reverend Stang?
Somebody's and he is about to join us here on the radio.
The radio scribe of the Church of the Subgenius has arrived. He is in the building.
Exclusive New Year's Revolution show.
Stang. The alternative apocalypse.
Stang.
It won't be long now.
Of the Reverend Stang.
Wait for
Stang.
Those dulcet tones.
Stang.
Listen to the concepts carefully.
Yes, dear friend.
Try to absorb from
say
the master.
Over and over again, and you will appear. Yes, dear friend.
Stang.
Yes, dear friend. www.subgenius.com.
Stang in the butt by a wasp.
And he drug a phylo in on the bottom of his heel.
I wash the bottom of my shoes every
don't
time
say
I
hello.
Kick phylo's butt.
Don't say hello. When your phone stops ringing, you're on the air. Just go ahead. That's our policy,
go.
And we're not changing it now.
I'm hoping that Vice President Cheney will show up tonight.
Right now he's in the bunker changing into his thong. A lot of people saw that thong. A couple years ago, Burning Man, Chick Cheney, he showed up at the fashion show at Burning Man a couple years ago. And he was induced by Dr. Hal, who was emceeing the fashion show, to get loose and party down. And it wound up that Dick Cheney was wearing a thong. There were 40,000 people at the time at Burning Man. Immediately, 20,000 people left. It was.
And they took their foreskins with them.
And they took all their foreskins with them.
The sacred foreskin, Calcata, Italy.
It isn't the one. You're still going to get wet.
Kitty and baby.
I hope it isn't it.
The sacred lily.
Okay, that one didn't explode. Kitty, you have to drink it.
Uh-oh.
It's here.
Infant Philo's here now. Maybe we could trade infant Philo to the flying saucers for a burrito.
Yeah.
Are you still on security?
A big burrito, one for enough for all of us.
Hi, sir. Clear the field.
We're monitoring Philo's child. We're in constant contact with Philo's child. She's as good as on the planet of the Earth.
Very well. I'm coming down right now. Over north.
See, plague of the zombies.
Pretty soft.
The Reverend Ivan.
Well, I think
Stang
it's time to
frothy.
Frothy?
I don't know who has the froth. They better hand it over fast.
I'm frothless.
You see? The energy. The force packed in the rock itself.
Oh,
is
yeah.
Being
released. You should run home and get it.
I almost turned around and stopped.
So 8484425. Talk to a totally naked Bishop Joey. That's right, Bishop Joey.
Oh my God, he is naked.
Seminal and secular head of the First Church, the last world's fast growing stack of religion, 100% less dogmas, light religion, one holy day a year, and today is an infant April 1st. Is here and he's naked and he's sitting right here and he can talk to you. So
somebody get a sanitary wipe for that chair.
No, it's okay. It'll clean up really nice with a hose when we hose down the studio at the end of the show at 5 a.m. So you talk to Bishop Joey now before he is not talkable. Any questions
what is
you
he
have?
Doing, you're doing to the microphone.
Oh, let me rub it. Let me rub it right. I got a little itch. Oh, I got an itch. Let me scratch it right. Oh, does that feel good? So talk to totally naked Bishop Joey. That's right. Call 848-4425. And any question, anything, any subject. I don't know. You know, and I got an answer for you. So
after careful study of the Bible.
real close.
Reverend William Miller thought that the end was 1834.
Tuesday.
He changed his mind and decided it was 1836. Then he recalculated it and found that it was 1843 in the month
Wednesday.
Of April.
There used to be six to choose from.
This was
now
to prove one of the
four.
Biggest events of the end time calendar. When April came, and Miller set to work on a new date. Miller's brave new choice, March 21st, 1844, for the end of the world. The Millerites waited in droves and high vantage points in special ascension robes for the expected end. Hysteria reigned. People sold up farms and homes. But still, frustratingly, the end did not come. They are not persistent. The Church of the Subgenius will not give up on the end of the world.
Order your end of the world now, 848-4425. We'll specially deliver it to you.
That can be done.
Personalized.
Subjective end of the world. It's
personalized.
When they're gone.
Yeah.
I can take care of it.
When would you like the end of the world? We'll deliver.
Closed society. It is closed society.
45 caliber end of the world.
Oh, it's magic. Everything we don't understand is magic.
Hold on. I shall pinch an Eve outbound to 1205 Zulu. Providence Control wants to know where is he. Pinch an Eve 262. Who's got him? Pinch an Eve?
Dolly's cleared from Zulu to Zulu. Bring an arm.
What's done? Runs the computation.
A prophet in Latvia predicted the end of the world for 1920. His followers believed with such fervor that they dug graves and waited beside them for the end. Some may still be there.
Computer god that controls you.
6 seconds after blastoff. Firing time, 2233 hours, 36 seconds.
Listen to your radio. Listen to your radio. Believe. Your radio.
You have no choice.
Well,
trust.
I don't want to alarm anybody over there, but I just had to let you know.
Yeah.
And I don't know if this is one of the signs of the apocalypse or not, but
could be.
Jones has been my lover for at least about 3.5 years now.
Yeah. Who has?
And Grace Jones.
Grace Jones.
Grace Jones.
Grace Jones, the disco singer.
Oh, yes. In your mind she has, and in my mind she was mine too.
She's
those long legs.
You'd have to Humphrey Bogart scaring me.
Fabulous.
My alien lover.
Grace Jones.
Grace Jones.
Is your sweetheart's sweetheart, then the end of the world is nigh.
That is.
Because there's no justice, my friend.
I don't know about any of that, but I know who my lover is. And she's a wonderful priestess. She's a goddess. She's a teacher. She's just magical.
Well, if you make of her a magical object and put her picture on the wall and prostrate yourself before it, she becomes magical
she
for you.
She is actually on the wall, not a picture. She is actually hanging on the wall right now.
Oh, dear.
Just like in...
Did the police know?
Oops, sorry.
It sounds uncomfortable like anyway. You didn't thumbtack her to the wall, did you? She's skinny enough you could use thumbtacks.
Oh, she's still alive.
Yeah, but don't forget, she might actually be magic.
Well, yeah, Grace Jones, you know, there is a kind of Aoife sort of vibe.
No, it's easy to
her.
Say. I know why you're saying it, but she actually could be magic. Do you understand me?
Well, she is. And
No, I know it's easy to say that.
Point,
right, I know. Yeah.
I had macaroni and cheese for dinner, too.
Yeah.
There were, you know, many of the great performers, were, in fact, shamanistic. Jim Morrison and Grace Jones. Sometimes she had her shamanistic moments.
She is a shamanistic moment, just like my macaroni and cheese.
You've got sacred macaroni.
You're spending
and cheese.
An evening at home. I love it. With your family.
Macaroni and cheese is like my peyote. It's my personal peyote, but it's macaroni.
Suddenly,
and,
without warning,
products.
Excuse me.
Macaroni and cheese could be mind-altering, properly treated.
Well, I believe it is mind-altering.
And if you look close enough at anything, I don't take acid anymore. But when I was a teenager, about 19 years old, I occasionally did. And I remember looking at a pile of
What are you saying?
And no, it was rice. A pile of rice.
No, not you. Him.
A pile of rice.
And it was good Lord!
Aww.
A manifestation from the other side, the Reverend Stang.
So good to see you. It's
did you say if you play one thing at a time, you get more out of it? Is that what you said?
Well, you should.
It's Don Hagen
Brenner. Oh,
John Schirlenbrenner.
I think it's about time for another ginger ale, so I will see you on the flip side at the zoo.
Okay. You want to drink that crap? Go right ahead.
Rice.
I drink club soda by
hand.
I hallucinated that it was an eternal plate of rice. That's what happened. Reverend Stang.
Oh, that
is here.
Feels so much better.
Stang from Cleveland.
He's just made himself. He just
right.
Found another way to introduce slack with a belch.
That wasn't me.
Well, we understand you've been sucking all the slack. Stang. Explain.
We're trying to understand why Cleveland is such a violent place.
Yes.
And one theory is that you get so much slack, people there are stressed out and begin to kill each other.
No, actually, the New Subgenius headquarters is not in Cleveland at all, but in Cleveland Heights, which sacrifices the slack of the rest of Cleveland for its own extremely low crime rate. I live in a kind of a little enclosed fortress. The Slacker Mansion, call it.
So what, Texas is just on its own now, right?
Oh, you be sorry. Actually, when I go to Texas, now I just came from there.
The desolate flats of Texas.
It rains. It rains if I visit Texas. When I leave, it stops raining. It didn't rain for a year. At least not in Stang County, unfortunately.
Until we understand it,
some parts of Texas got the Katrina. That's right.
What is this? Time check, everyone.
So there was like a locus of global warming, a cell of global warming settled over the state after you left.
Well, when we had to flee Texas, we placed a curse upon the benighted state of Texas that there would be no rain until such time as we returned. And that's
what kind of a vehicle did you flee Texas in? I'm curious.
United Airlines in this case.
Oh, so you
yeah,
got,
but he drove it on the freeway. That was the curious thing.
You got to Cleveland without a car?
People had to drive off the road to let the 747 drive by.
Oh, no,
when
we fled Texas to Cleveland, we went in a series of covered wagons across the prairie. We faced many hardships, droughts, locusts, plagues.
Those were the old steam wagons.
Rednecks.
Right?
Yeah. Well, no, we were the rednecks.
All right.
But,
all right.
It's all relative. oh, it's a tale to make the Mormons cringe. The Exodus from Texas. It kind of has a rhyme, kind of a ring to it. Exodus from Texas.
Exodus from Texas.
Texodus.
Texodus.
Reverend Stang, I have a press release from the Church of the Subgenius. Can I ask you about this?
I heard you reading that in the limo on the way here. And I thought to myself, that sounds like a Reverend Motomac press release.
The Church is inviting all of its members worldwide to gather together for the final hours in Sherman, New York, from Thursday, July 5th, at a clothing optional outdoor campground. I'm very interested to read. The Church has been engaged in a massive recruitment campaign to increase the numbers of its membership for the arrival of the Exodus. Is seeking performers and producers from the adult entertainment industry.
Yeah, that's right. We have a new adult film festival award ceremony that just started last year. It's a way to broaden the artistic reach of the Church and also to get a certain amount of attention. If you think about it, you know. And a lot of the saints of the Church have been workers in the, shall we say, sex industry. Kitten Natividad, the great saints Swiss, Kitten Natividad, John Holmes, and some of the other the greats.
Saint Wad.
The giants, you might say, especially the clumpers.
Yeah.
I have a special place in my heart, a very large hole in my heart where the plumper is.
Yeah, and it's still dripping, too, that hole, isn't it?
Until they understand it.
They got some discharge.
So, July 5th, it's all coming to an end, and
yes,
it does every year, basically. I mean,
well,
we have a new apocalypse every year, and in my opinion, my theory is that other people who predict the end of the world, I read a list of them, you might have heard some
of
them.
Yeah, we did. I heard that on the way.
Other people
in.
Are not diligent enough about bringing about the end of the world and predicting the end of the world, and the Church of the Subgenius has to be praised for its persistence. It will not give up.
Oh, our faith is absolute. The aliens, the Exodus, will arrive on July 5th, 1998, which obviously has not arrived yet. Bob said that date, therefore, that date
that
has not yet arrived.
It was upside down. It's a typo.
There's been this whole tampering with calendars, which is pretty obvious. I mean, come on.
Does anybody really know what time it is?
No,
we don't know what
calendar.
Year this is. We don't even know what
the numbers
planet.
Seem to swim around when I look at them. When I look at my calendar, the numbers seem to wobble and swim, and but then everything else is.
Oh, everybody's so sure that this is the year 2007. Everybody's so sure this is planet Earth.
Yeah,
it's planet Earth.
It's not. It's not. You're right, Ivan. This is not planet Earth. It's just
Mars.
What we named it. That doesn't
we don't
mean
know what the name of this planet
is. Planet Earth.
Somebody's going to come and tell us the name one day.
Our
you mean
whole reality
Schwartnick?
We name everything.
Our reality is based on a house of cards, a teetering edifice that could fall any time because it's built on a bunch of hooey. Yes,
hooey.
I'll say it. Hooey is what it's built. Foundation hooey. Of hooey. A bunch of hoo-ha.
Look at this. You can just walk.
Who's playing...
2007. 2 and 7 means...
Who's playing that song?
Add them together,
way down
it's
low.
9. Maybe it's the year 9.
Everybody be quiet a minute. Hang
1998
on.
1998
is... This is a test. Hang on. Who is playing that song way down low? Who's playing that? Anybody here?
No.
Really?
No.
What the hell is that?
I don't know.
It's like some 70s power band.
Wait, who would expect some kind of random weird noise in the background on this show?
There's some kind of radio show going on under ours.
It sounds like
I heard some Phineas.
It's country music.
Just download Phineas Narco. I heard it that for a second.
There was a reference to Phineas Narco.
Hooey.
He may assert himself in some...
Ha ha hooey.
You know, radio waves can impinge themselves mysteriously.
The silent radio.
Until we understand it and master it.
They will have to continue spending that $30.
Listen to that. What is that? Who is that? I've never.
It's in the right ear, isn't it?
I know. Yeah. It's only in the left ear. Your headphones are backwards.
Your ears are on backwards.
I'd like to find out what that is.
God, it sounds like Judy Collins or
how could that be happening?
I think it's a ghost of a folk song show that was in this KPFA studio. And
it's
that?
Puzzling evidence who just isn't even here. He just turned something on and left the room with this.
I can't imagine something like that.
Let him listen to this in the background, he said.
What is he even playing this for?
What a surprise.
He's out propinating and subjecting us to
folk music.
What's
wrong with him?
Folk music.
All right. Listen to that. Blessed silence.
There is folk music.
It always feels better when you turn it off.
All right. Go ahead.
Trust your radio.
Okay.
Trust me.
Oh!
Ow!
I win every time. Wethead. Towel off.
No way.
1-0-8-4-8-4-4-2-5.
Is that what year this is? That maybe that's what year this is. What year is it? If
missed,
it's not 2007, what year is it?
If you missed that first number,
we cannot know.
This is it.
5.
That's it.
It's the year 5.
1.
You've got 1,993 years till the end.
8-4-8-4-4-2-5.
And tell us what time it is, where you're at.
Hello,
and tell
Mr.
us where you're at. And tell us what you call
slave,
where you're at.
Parody puppet, you
if you're Chinese, it's a different year.
Member of the master race.
That's not the real Francis Deck. That is an imposter
Deck.
Oh,
it's That's right. That's right. Death. I read about this. Someone, a guy at a radio station, remade his text.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, the true Francis Deck.
But it's a lot better than him.
Never
though.
Have been able to enunciate those words
no,
so well.
No, that's what I figured. It's probably better that it isn't.
What about
students in the maybe Logic University course in the Subgenius History, the first 100 years?
Yes,
are
I have
able
it right
to
here.
Download the original Francis Deck texts.
Did he ever read his own text?
I don't know. But I did get a copy of the original things that he would staple onto telephone poles.
Yeah.
That he was able to use every bit of a page like a true visionary always does.
The corners, everything.
Yeah, all the corners. He would type until the thing was full and then put his final thoughts along the margins.
But what about
sideways.
This? What about the back?
Well, we don't know.
You didn't turn it over? You get a valuable document like that and you don't even turn it over?
Well, we've got Xeroxes, and you can't tell which is page one or
there's
page
two.
There's two-sided
Xeroxes now.
Rant.
Come on.
Yeah, sure. Now, yeah, sure. This was in the day, man, back
what?
In the past.
What day?
1,000 years
Tuesday.
Ago, when the Church of the Subgenius was first inspired
when,
into existence.
When was he doing this? Early 80s? Is that right?
Francis Deck?
Yeah.
I got my Xerox in the early 80s, yes. 1982.
4 billion eyesight television camera genie, communist gangster computer god, master race,
testing,
pure
testing.
Living, thinking, mad, deadly, worldwide
now,
communist
now,
gangster
the person
god.
Reading the deck text is J.R. Bob Dobbs.
Of course, I knew
is this,
that.
Is this thing on?
But listen, that guy in San Francisco, do you know the guy who's putting out the, what is it, the set of CDs called from Monster God Computer, Communist Monster God Computer, something, that's his label, and he's putting out all these outtakes and bloopers and people freaking out. And
gosh, what
celebrity,
an idea.
Celebrity bloopers, but his label is named the Mad Conspiracy Computer, whatever, the Communist God thing. That's his label. So I wondered if it was the same guy by any chance. Is Deck dead?
Yes.
Oh, good.
Yes, and in fact, some lads from Dallas went and videotaped him on his deathbed in a cruel mockery of his condition.
Well, I'm glad somebody did.
I'm not
it's
really
a pretty
aware
boring
of Deck.
Video.
Do you have any tapes of him or something?
That was him.
That was him.
Well, that was someone reading the rants of
worldwide living death Frankenstein slavery.
This is his writing.
Living death Frankenstein slavery.
This is his writing with someone pretending
well,
to be him.
Well, if you listen to it, it applies to that.
Actually, he's right about that.
It was like a Nostradamus.
It's quite amazing.
Only a lot more specific.
I mean, this is from the early 80s, and I'm still playing it, which shows you how relevant it's still is after all this time.
What if it had been 20 years later?
Oh,
not you, Gary.
The man-made inside-out planets with nucleonic-powered speeds much faster than the speed of light. Look up and see the gangster computer god concocted new fake starry sky. The worldwide, completely controlled, deadly, degenerative climate and atmosphere to the new
it's like an anticipation of the Matrix concept.
Well, Alex Jones certainly has some explaining to you that Mr. Francis Deck
exactly positioned satellites to new fake phony stars.
Phony stars, says
I can say lots of things. Tuna fish, parentheses, coochie coochie girl charo, sing nut ranch.
There's a theory that our universe is the creation of another universe.
Only one more hour to go.
It's a gigantic experiment in some kind of computer program. There is a perfectly reputable theory for that.
That cuts it hardware, boy.
So that guy, you know, he may have been the best.
No skinny pink boy's gonna tell me how to say things on my show.
What is that?
What sort of sound is that?
I should say that fanaticism consists in thinking some one matter so overwhelmingly important that it outweighs
everything
else.
That sounds like I feel. I have the pain of 10,000 arthritic old men all the time.
What do you have
against Canadians?
Really?
Yes.
I have nothing against Canadians. I'm playing Bob and Doug right now, as a matter of fact, to show my love for Canada.
What about us? Get out.
I got
the wives of 10,000 arthritic old men.
You're blowing the floor.
Old men.
Philo has the flatulation of them.
So, Hoser, what are you talking about?
Put our clothes back on, huh?
Way to go.
Okay, Hoser, no, that's optional.
Flatulation of 10,000 arthritic old men.
Okay. And there was.
And then.
Don't pick your nose.
Part of our album.
Reverend Sting.
Oh, good day.
I have to return to this, my apocalyptic theme, because I am the purveyor of the signsofwitness.com website. I'm reporting for it. I've got to ask you this. What will the apocalypse be like? We know what the party is going to be like a little bit before, but when the actual end comes, could you describe a little bit what it would be like?
Well, it will depend on how...
Besides a blessed relief, I mean.
Well... Individuals who never irritated any subgeniuses in any way during their lives will have it much easier than those who...
Are we going to go back to the other world?
Because they'll die instantly, practically. Yeah, the ones
like switching
that
off a light.
At some point in their lives irritated a subgenius or inconvenienced one, however inadvertently, will see the pains associated with hell. The Dante-style hell, as well as modernized versions.
This could be a widespread belief. Just think how quickly you'd go through the airport, through security. Oh, it's the Reverend Stan going right through. You'd have the... Wouldn't you like to sit in first class, Reverend Stan?
Oh, well, there won't be airports after the end. Well, there may
be airports.
They'll be the kind of airports... where you're waiting in line with 5,000 other people for
and there will be radio like this one. KPFA and KPFB in Berkeley, KFCF in Fresno.
Radio.
That's right.
KPFA.org.
We'll have to do this show
online.
24 hours a day because there's nothing else to listen to. We'll hate
gotta
it.
Gotta throw it up for the Barcelona.
Nightmare.
Just like us.
Michael.
That was the way it used to
Michael
be. There was nothing but the show
Jackson.
For 24 hours
Michael
a day.
Jackson.
And how
Michael
far
Jackson.
We have fallen.
Michael.
It's only eight or 5 hours a day now.
Michael
people
Jackson.
Will pay for the show.
I only do this for about an hour.
Get old, you can only
in the
abuse your body most
Michael
of the time.
Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson.
Oh, Kathy. Gary Gabrofriend is making these noises this time.
A mysterious device.
They're live. This isn't a Bob Nelson background tape. It's not one of Wellman's movie soundtrack collections.
Would have made the mascara snake joyful.
It's not something Don Joyce is providing. It's just not... you, Gary. You, Gary, that hair, it's just not you.
It's just not me.
It has a life of its own.
Those shoes, those just aren't you, Gary. Not you. They're not you, Gary.
You know, it's getting so the teenage girls only grab the bottom half of my hair now and they leave the top half alone. What do you think that means?
It's growing farther down towards your crotch.
That's a little hint.
The rest of you are all cocks.
Just a subtle hint.
In the crowd.
Just a scruttle hint.
9 to 5, no one.
It's their way of saying,
you're
not,
all cannon
not
fodder.
You, Gary.
Are you here? You're the guys in red shirts on Star Trek. Get out!
Reverend Stang, have you seen Idiocracy yet?
No, I have not seen Idiocracy, although you're the third person in about 2 days to mention it. I just, as soon as it's downloadable, I'm sure I'll have
it
a copy.
It is downloadable.
Oh, well, as soon as I'm home, I'll download it.
Let's just watch it.
From my favorite channel. Which channel is it on?
Don't play it with your brother.
I don't know, but they have the Fox News channel on it. It's 500 years in the future.
Oh, cool.
Hello, baby.
Well, my favorite channel is alt.binaries.movies.gibbics.
Yes. It's on there.
That's one of those non-pay channels.
Hello, baby. Hello, baby.
that's the Drummond family in the background. That's all they do is they spoil, they talk to their baby. Hello, baby. Hello, baby. Hello, baby. That's Philo's rant now.
I remember the
baby
old
has a very powerful mind, and it has taken them over completely.
It has, actually. That baby might as well be running their lives. They'll drop everything they're doing
well.
Just for that baby.
Why do they say sleep like a baby when babies wake up every 2 hours?
Tall. To take an example.
What it really means to babies are not the case.
It means that stuff runs out of your mouth and your both ends while you're sleeping.
But if you
that's what sleep like a baby really means. It means you have to be cleaned up after the sleep.
Was so atrocious.
Princess Wee has just
no
walked
other
in,
cruelty should
but
be
seems not to have
better.
Her own microphone
yes.
or it even a better. Chair.
Now,
the lady just entered the room, boys.
Shortly take the next rocket out, in fact. I've been holding the fort.
There's a chair in there. You can go sit, if you dare to sit next to Phineas Narco. Yes, Princess, we are Doe, queen of all the UFOs, but only the unidentified. O's.
Could she intercede for us when the UFOs come in the next day? Could we fall to our knees in front of her and beg her to intercede
so that
they don't turn us in?
No, because when they come, then they're no longer unidentified. You know what
is her relationship with known objects?
That's the drawback to being that particular kind of queen.
Identified flying objects, then.
Yeah, what about
IFOs?
Known flying objects? What
she's
she
got no... Those are out of her jurisdiction.
Really?
Those aren't her responsibility.
Want to play with me?
Oh, man. It's the
60s. Have I done something wrong?
Bob's still in college.
Where's Glass Madness to sing a little Bob song?
I'm Bob better than your Bob, because your Bob sucks. He sucks so bad.
The old Slack Bob.
He can kiss my wallet goodbye.
La la la.
That sucky little Bob.
Hey, we Wotan.
All praise the moon.
Did I hear a little tiny caller?
Must I help you? Oh, breath mint.
Guitar,
I'll
do anything. Watch it play me.
Not Hugh Carey is playing the guitar by rubbing it just against the hairs of his face, which are like guitar picks.
People will be praying for the end of the world if it doesn't happen, my friend.
Oh, people will be praying for the end of the show if it doesn't change atmosphere somehow.
5 hours tonight, Over the Edge and the Puzzling Evidence Show combined.
Bishop Joey is really working out on that drum set up there.
We're going till 5.
If only the musicians could hear each other.
And no one can stop us.
If only we could hear each other.
I hear the
time
ocean,
is now.
And I hear my time
seconds to blast off.
Hey, guess what, you guys? I've learned that I'm losing my hearing.
What?
They
huh?
always do that.
They cannot help themselves.
Yeah.
Well, should we yell louder or what?
Hey,
yeah,
I found
that actually
hearing.
Helps. Quite a bit.
You have headphone volume controls under the desk there. The little knobs near every jack. They don't turn it up nearly.
That's not a volume. No.
They don't nearly turn it up high enough, but it's better than nothing.
Well, it's not the jacks or the phones or even the show. It's unfortunately my ears. You know, I'm really, really, really old.
Well, you're mighty close to an electric guitar right now. I'd watch out.
Yeah, that's part of the problem. Too many years spent filming my friends' bands standing in front of the speaker. And now I hear these crickets all the time. I used to think they were real crickets. I moved to Ohio, and in the dead of winter, I princess, we would say, listen, hear that? I go, well, yeah, I hear the crickets.
What kind of vehicle did you use to move to Ohio?
I know these.
Is there a history of this?
We used slaves, actually, to haul
Bobby's.
The church building itself.
You must have got out just in time.
Brick by brick.
And that's
well, this
what
was
said
Texas under George Bush.
Before.
So it wasn't that expensive. You know, it wasn't a union. The unions were still out of it. They weren't there yet. We were able to move the church stone by stone, so to speak, as it were. Brick by brick, floppy disk by floppy disk.
Did you move your crop brick by brick, or did you move it?
We moved the frog.
They moved the building. They found something horrible underneath it.
Over there.
Well, I named my frog
Festering, a festering excrescence.
And Spoman Pachawa.
And affecting their mind all those years.
Dr. Drummond finally arrived. I heard Princess Wee's cackle.
Actually, I've been here just lurking about, listening and calculating, as it were. I've been repositioning my monitors.
I've
been recalibrating my whistle.
There he is. Yeah.
Pucker up your lips.
We're swinging as we pucker. We're pinging and sluckering.
You're swuckering, pingering.
KPFA. The world's only radio.
All right, well, in that case, I got to get my wall wart. I have a wall wart, and I didn't say Walmart, but I said wall wart.
Welcome to Walmart. I love you.
So I'm just going to say,
you know, look, how, the price how long fell. Will it be before all of us are working as greeters at Walmart?
I'm going to get a job there.
Walmart
soon.
World.
I already am.
I know I can get a job there because that will meet my standard of brain power.
Well, they don't teach us at Walmart. That's one thing about it. I mean, they may not pay you well or give you any benefits, but they don't teach us.
Hello. Welcome to Walmart.
They do?
Yes, and after 20 years, they give you a shirt.
Don't teach. You want a cart? No.
I live in that place and they never know.
People do. I do now. People do.
But do they give you a sincerity test?
There's plenty of food.
Yeah, what fluid did they take out for a sincerity test?
There's a mattress department.
I don't know, but it comes out of the base of your skull.
Toilets open all night?
Yeah.
Snack food galore?
His sincerity fluid is slightly too viscous.
TVs, DVDs, CDs.
Dr. Drummond would have to use somebody else's.
Well, he could get a
totally depleted on the sincerity solution.
Clothing. You never run out of clothing in Walmart.
In fact, I was going to try to get a depletion allowance for my lack of sincerity.
If you were living in Walmart, you'd be home now.
I've got some synthetics.
The Reverend John Shirley...
I think it should be worth some kind of government subsidy.
The Piss Baptist must go on about his Piss Baptist duties.
You know, there are 10,000 people lined up in the Grand Canyon waiting for me.
And I'm a sincerian, you know.
There's enormous vats next to the Grand Canyon that I use to keep, you know, my fluids, the other fluids, replenished and flowing. And everybody is very grateful. They're very grateful.
Let John Shirley's mercy rain down.
You know, the Forest Service is not allowed to say how old the Grand Canyon is. This is
That's
a fact.
What I've heard, yeah.
They're not allowed to say this. They said they were going to change that policy. They were going to stop selling that book about how the Grand Canyon's only 4,000 years old. They haven't done it. Because
that would infringe on the rights of creationists to state theories of ancient science.
The rights of creation.
Wow, I'm really hungry. My stomach is rumbling.
Ignorance. I read in the newspaper that 29% of Americans, I find this hard to believe, but some new survey, 29% of Americans believe that the sun revolves around the earth.
It doesn't? Are you saying it doesn't?
Okay, 29
0.01, I guess.
It sounds believable to me. I mean, I can believe in a supernatural being that's been around since the beginning of time with no evidence at all. Why can't I believe in something as equally believable as what you claim?
That appears to be the logic. Yeah.
Varlar, you can believe
I'm not making it
anything that you want to believe. You can be what you want.
You can believe what you want, too.
Anything you want, because when you grow up, you can do anything you want. I'm very proud of you, young man.
My stomach is really rumbling.
You know, it's playing a rumba.
Do what thou want.
Do what he won't. You've heard, do what thou wilt shall be the whole of the law. But for the subgenius, it's do what they won't shall be
do
the whole of the
Jesus
law. Do what they won't.
And the engine of the train
you
weighs
will.
Something like 80,000 tons.
They won't, but you will.
What would Jesus not do?
Who would Jesus do?
I forget the actual weight.
Magdalene is
WWNJ, NDJ. GWBBQ.
Surely he was
like
a hog.
Somebody wants to get in.
Princess Wea's
sacred microphone is ready.
You know, it turned out Princess Wea was actually the daughter of Darth Vader. The Dr. Doom.
Singer from outer space?
Yeah, Dr. Doom, one of those guys. One of those mascots. Amino acids. I'm going to escort the Fist Baptist to his limousine helicopter.
Well, doing the show is sort of like trying to jump on a big man.
Dear friend.
This is what it sounds like in my brain just before I go to bed.
Strap in for firing.
Can you take it off?
I know that you think that sounds funny.
Security, five. Report.
Okay, now I've got some catalogs here I want to read from.
Warning, arm. Ready.
Do you have my catalogs ready?
10 seconds.
I'm ready to recite my catalog copy now.
This is Charles Collins at a testing laboratory in Houston, Texas. Switches have just been turned.
There was already so much money.
The human being is about to receive an outer shape.
That many fingers with lots of zeros.
That will have a wrinkle or decay.
Have you ever asked yourself how much are major companies willing to pay you to create a show like this one? It's true, from health supplements to credit cards. They do it because it's good, and it can bring in millions. This is like a dream come true. I have a retired lifestyle and $39 to spend.
The streets of New York City.
But I didn't care. Remember, there's no risk. No risk. I let go of my hair a long time ago. It seemed to be getting like a ever increasingly disharmonious endeavor. So I decided, along with my $10,000, to check into the local. I was reading Bob's note, and there I found out that he was a great guy. and a very successful copywriter. You'll be hearing a lot about him once you start our new program.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Oh, yes. Okay.
Can you really hear me?
God.
Can you really hear me?
How can you, swiftly can you change your career?
Okay, all right. We arranged the
show now.
We just the show can start now because we rearranged the studio into three sectors. There's two sectors for married people and their children. And then there's the main room, which is for the lonely geeks. Phineas, Don Joyce, and Puzzle, and the sad old bachelors. Weeping. You can hear them weeping, hollering.
Conspiracy over 300 years ago. Ideally, tiny brain and pointing finger gangster to government eyesight, TV gangster spy cameras. Computer God, new world order degeneration. With gifted, with all gangster brains, not in control of nigger deadly gangster parody, puppets or nigger brain programmed robots.
He said the N word.
Degenerative disease to internal.
Let's say that.
Frankenstein, slavery, overall.
Get out of my pills! Leave my pills alone! He's just like Philo. Bishop Joey is just like Philo. He reached in, he just transgressed my personal space.
Violated me.
I feel raped.
And it was good, too. I love violating your personal spaces.
I feel raped. I feel huge.
Yeah, because we here at the one pretty true church, first church of the last laugh, kicks the sub genie's ass every time.
Listen to that fake Texas accent.
Every time.
That is the fakest Southern accent.
So fake. Oh, you look at these boots. Smell the bottom of my boots. Huh?
That's the fakest smelling cow hockey I ever smelled.
Well, just look at my Billy Bob t-shirt.
Every time. Billy Bob is a poser. Is that my tinnitus or is that the show?
It's the show, dear. It's just the show.
It's gotten to where my hearing, really, it's true. My hearing's gotten so bad that Princess Wee has to translate for me, and she plays tricks on me by mistranslating things. The waitress says, that'll be $30. And Princess Wee says, she says she wants to have a three-way. And then I end up humiliated and embarrassed. And they all think it's funny. People make fun of old deaf persons like myself. Now, I don't want to forget my students in the subgenius How to Make Your Own Cult, Do's and Don'ts. Oh, K-Rob has arrived. The mighty K-Rob, that means the sound quality may improve.
Uh-huh.
Listeners, there is hope.
Undoubtedly.
Oh, no. Michael Pepe, as I suspected.
Michael Pepe
even arrived. That means the station will be on the air for another half an hour or so before the Pepe effect works in. Six.
Forward,
you know, Pepe kind of looks like Philo's new daughter. Michael Pepe has a new... No, that's Philo, not his daughter. Philo's daughter is the one with the mutton chops in the other room. Yes, but Dr. Drummond and Mrs. Chaos McBobcat have brought their baby, their new infant child, Michael Pepe.
You can hear it crying now.
Pardon me, Michael, I'm in headphones and you're not on a mic, so I can't. Nothing makes sense. He said something about how many eyes does it have.
Want me to take it out? Like,
only three.
Like, touch it.
Actually, my nephew, Alex, today asked a question. He seriously asked me, hey, if you had three eyes, would you be able to see the fourth dimension? And I said no, because the fourth dimension isn't something that you see. So eyes are not the sense organ you need.
Your
time sense would be able to.
It's something you smell in the future.
Somehow,
is it like the future a sense of smell?
Will you see the fifth dimension? Well, they broke up. The fifth dimension, I think, broke up.
Enter your credit
fourth dimension
cool. By the pound sign now.
What is that noise four, in the background? Is that the show?
Yeah, it's puzzling evidence. He puts on weird things and he leaves.
Without a credit card. Just dial 1-510.
Michael Pepe, you have to get on a microphone for anyone to hear you. I'm deaf now, so I've been reading your lips so far, but the radio audience can't hear that. He thinks I'm joking.
These kids these days, they just walk around like zombies.
We just cussed each other out in sign language. Hey, I learned sign language the other day. The sign, okay, radio listeners, the sign for sex is this. And the sign for cactus is this, spiky, spiky. So when you see somebody you want to have kinky sex with, you go like that and then spiky, spiky. The sex symbol, of course, is the old Temple of Devo with the finger. That's the formal, polite way of saying sex. Now, if you turn your fingers around like this, that's butt sex, or 60 in 69 is like that. The sex symbol, friends, is actually two fingers of each hand tapping together on the end. Like if you made two little figures that could walk along the tabletop using your fingers, you put those two figures together and tap them together.
Yeah, but Uranus is not a planet. Uranus is not a planet. My anus is.
Now you have to get on a microphone, Michael, or it doesn't really, nothing you say really exists.
Is that Michael Poopay?
Now, my students listening.
Michael Poopay. Give me the hook. Get the hook. Get the hook.
Maybe logic.org class, online class in the Church of the Subgenius, should know that this is the Subgenius business meeting.
Michael Pepe's here, so I have to hook myself up.
Business meeting. And,
what is the business?
The business is we're trying to untangle the true history of the church. Bob assigned us to do a commission to study what went wrong during the previous church administration. The previous administration of the church made many mistakes, and we're trying to delineate what happened decade by decade since, well, for the last 100 years.
Yeah.
It has to do with
then what happened?
The bad karma having to do with the elimination of the Gary factor.
Once Gary was
eliminated. Well, not you, Gary, finally added up to where the church is going to suffer. Gary.
No.
And right now,
actually, that started several years ago on July 7th. 1987, when Gary stormed out of the studio saying, I've had it with you guys. Don't call me, I'll call in the show.
I remember that. That was the funniest thing he ever did.
That was. I hated to say that, but I'm glad you just put that out on the table. Because I wanted to comment on that, but I really didn't want to be the one to bring the subject up.
I thought it was a great bit.
Now, one point of contention is, when exactly was J.R. Bob Dobbs born? Some say that it was in the early 20s. But we're looking now at 1927 or 1929.
It was a midnight clear. We know that.
Yeah. We know it was on a midnight clear, and we know that it was in a cheap motel.
How else could they land?
We know that in 1945, Bob killed Hitler again, and he met Philo in 1950 in college.
Well, you know, that means I'm old.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Gramps. Now, in 1953, Bob was immaculated, and the countdown to X Day began. Unfortunately, it ended prematurely.
Lunch.
And had to start again, but we don't know where to start exactly because we don't know where it ends.
Hey, welcome to school. I'm Principal Bob McKenzie.
In 1955, Bob had his second prevision.
My vice principal, Doug.
And in 1956, Princess Wea was born.
Good, eh?
When did Bob get sterno triggered?
1955.
Sterno was pregnant.
1955.
And then 8 years later,
Jane
was born.
Oh, that's right. That's right. It says Sager. In 1957, some bad boys got me to sit on a cactus by telling me it was the king's throne.
Those evil bastards.
And my parents spent the afternoon pulling tiny cactus spines out of my behind.
You're lucky you didn't have my parents. They pounded the cactus spice in the room.
Well, I was spoiled. I'll admit it. Yeah, I was a spoiled child.
Please, I was born in a place like
this. In 1959, Bob started producing movies. Like
is this KPFA or is this
DC? Attack of the Giant Shrew People.
It's KP Your Mama.
I didn't get that criticism.
KPFU, man.
It was undoubtedly a criticism, but I couldn't make it out. If you could call back and criticize us again, we would very much appreciate it.
We'll all be quiet and listen to your criticisms, your constructive criticisms.
He said something like, is this KPFA or is this? And then I missed it. So I don't know what we were being compared with.
Yeah.
It's like the mad god, communist, insane, you know.
Rant people.
Yes.
Like absolutely helpless and hopeless, simple language, mongrel, mulatto, exploited niggers.
Pardon me. Language. Now, in 1960, Bob discovered that nails, as they gradually emerge step by step out of boards, cause hammers to fly up and down with human hands gripping them on one end.
Isn't that what everyone really
That was Bob's great discovery about cause and effect.
Anything is possible today.
You don't hammer a nail. The nail causes the hammer to go up and down with a human gripping.
And how do you feel about that, Sam?
I feel satisfied that the church has progressed as predicted. If this was the year 1963.
And Mantle's still alive.
Well, this is
Claire
the noisiest show. Princess, we think how pleasant our show hour of Slack is.
I'm trying to control it, but it's out of
hand.
It's
like chaos. It's got a mind of its own.
It's got a Don Joyce of its own.
This is Walter Boone at Times Square in New York City, returning you to Charles Collins in Texas.
Five, now, four, three,
Charles
two,
Collins
one.
Again. As I look at the strange devices before me, I find it difficult to understand or even believe.
I believe it. I believe that this show sounds better when they play tapes of other shows on it.
Good work, everyone.
But I knew what to expect when I was born. They told me. They gave me instructions for life when I was born. And told me what to expect.
Will you
Unlike other people. So you just have to blunder and bluff their way through. Unfortunately, I lost the instruction book when I was about five. I had to be toilet trained all over again.
We have a long day ahead of us, so we should begin with a two-hour recess.
I kept having to call tech support for that.
Get up and go out. Go outside. Good day. Okay, there'll be smoke.
Say it out, outside.
Operation.
Security.
This show reminds me of my hearing test, which I flunked.
My boy. Now to wait till someone phones in where the pieces fell.
Gary Gabrogfred here has a special electronic guitar that every time he touches one of the strings, it creates a whole new show. It's like a sampler. And each note of each string has a separate show that plays back. Princess Wee is playing her messages over the microphone.
Our Our
Then maybe we'll be finally knowing what the flying saucers are.
Who are the masters of the UFO?
We!
Standing next to me is a technical expert.
A fanatical group all together have a comfortable feeling that they're all friends of each other.
The people who are not on a microphone in the other studio are all laughing because they're having fun. But the people who are on microphones and listening to the show all look grim.
It's really hard.
And maybe we should get off the microphones and join the party.
Just go jam.
Yeah.
Just go jam out.
No, the jamming is happening right here. Gary is doing all the jamming.
I'm just waiting till you jam this thing, you know,
it's a fire drill.
And he's been jamming it into the edge of the table and into the equipment. Jammed it into the microphone. Jammed it into his mouth.
Okay, light up.
Clambering cacophony of symphonic proportion.
They're all very much excited.
Does that mean it's cool?
You can see it in any political party. There's always a fringe of fanatics in any political party.
So a lot of people think the world's going to end 2012.
Yeah, but the reason they think that is because of the Mayan calendar running out of numbers, right?
Right. Well, that's Frank Zappa's birthday. Then.
But that's just another bunch of arbitrary numbers made by humans. Why should nature and the excess and the world ending depend on silly, arbitrary human numbering traditions?
Oh, it's just a
that's
coincidence.
Silly.
It's just a coincidence.
Oh, just a coincidence. Yeah, that's what they all say. Except for the scientists who say that it, nothing is a coincidence, and it's all a meaningful, mystical message from Bob. Well, some the real good scientists.
This is the mystical message music now. Let's get on with the mystical message.
Who perhaps can offer the
I thought the music and the sound was itself the mystical message.
The answer, Mr. That's Collins, lies in a system called the Baird Curing.
I thought the Baird Curing was the mystical message.
A surface each person lives within is treated with a chemical reactant in the kettle. It is then dried at low temperatures so as not to set the kettle. When we have the shape of each human being in question, we heat it with this device.
That educational film in the background is describing where babies come from.
Chicago.
That's pretty much where my...
Yeah, Chicago.
That's where my dad explained it that way.
Really?
He said babies are poured into a little mold. They have a mold, person mold, and they pour the baby juice in there, and the baby comes out.
That's what they mean by breaking the mold.
Babies came from friendly 13-year-old
girls. Really?
Yeah. Whose dad do you think was right?
Babies come from friendly 13-year-old girls, he said.
That's what he said.
In some countries, that is correct.
Yes.
In many countries, that's correct, as I keep reminding Princess Wee whenever we're watching a movie like Peter Pan or Lemony Snicket or Harry Potter. I go, look, you know, in many countries, those girls would be married by now. They'd be grandmothers.
Not quite grandmothers.
No, everyone, okay,
wrong with that.
The people in the third seat.
There's nothing wrong with it, is there? No, I mean, not that there's anything wrong with it. That's what they always say when
you
there really is something
Why?
Wrong with it.
Are you having some kind of attention deficit disorder?
They do.
Is that what's wrong with you?
And they feel pretty cozy with each other.
Hey, Reverend Stang, I got a couple of extra catalogs over here.
Oh, is it time to read catalogs, Dr. Drummond? You know, that's my favorite part of this show. When you read the catalogs at random.
Hold on a minute. I'm going to bring one over to you.
If it wasn't for that, I'd have nothing to edit out of your shows when I replay them on Hour of Slack. Yeah, I edit the best catalog readings out. Oh, he really does have a catalog. He just handed one to me. Now I can say, Dynamite, discount deals, authentic, serially proof lining, real leather, the Biltec, I can't do it as well as Dr. Drummond, though. Nobody can read a catalog like Philo.
Now it's easier than ever to stay
connected
with friends, family, and colleagues around the world.
Philo, I noticed that you're better at reading those catalogs right when Dr. Howell is coming to a dramatic crescendo.
Sleek, powerful, and completely portable. On the go, in the car,
I've studied
at home,
the dynamics of this show.
The perfect self-contained system. Eliminate the hassles.
But Dr. Drummond, what does that have to do with our topic?
Always
the true
make
mystery.
Clear.
Hey, is Bishop Joey running away? It's lucky son of a bitch.
Don't you remember every third word that the listeners are supposed to take the whole show, cut it up into pieces, extract every third word, compile it, then recite it backwards for the arcane secret messages hidden within. We can't do it where it's too easy. We have to, you know, perform some kind of upgrade, memory transfer, hard drive, refragmentation. Not a defrag this time, but a refrag. We're going to refrag the hard drive. We don't know why we have to do it. We're possessed to do it. But in the meantime,
instant plastic surgery, butchery, murder.
Are we going to get to the business portion of the show? When are we supposed to do the business meeting?
What is the business?
I've got a budget I got to tell you guys about. How I legally robbed a bank last month for over $87,978 and got away with it.
Well, let's split.
Let's split the money? Okay.
Both.
I don't mind because I'll easily make that much this month. Okay, now I want to know, how does the listener digest the show in such a way that it enters the brain pan according to the prescribed pathways?
Hey, I drained my brain pan last night. What's your excuse?
What? Really?
So, like, that's the announcement.
Except one thing. Ruin the lunchroom. What you're smelling is food. One thing is a burger.
And when that is spread about and is combined with a propensity to hate some other group, you get fanaticism well developed.
Good day. End of announcement.
No, sir, not yet. Captain McDonald is here, sir. He has a man with him, says you should see him immediately.
Well, all right, bring him in. Yes. McDonald thought you'd like to hear this, sir. This is Al Waters, a rancher from upstate. He flew down from his ranch this morning, reported to the state police. They sent him to us. The saucer?
Yes, sir.
Where is it, Mr. Waters, the wreck?
Wreck? I didn't see no wreck, sir.
What did you see?
I seen a flying saucer come down about half a mile from my ranch house. Started this morning when I was going after lost calf.
He swears the saucer's undamaged, Dr. Brunson.
Well, it may not be the one we... You flew down, Mr. Waters?
Yep, got my own jet plane.
Once done, it becomes impossible for that shape to ever wrinkle, sag, or bone.
Oh, Christ.
Test, test. Is this show still on?
Chest. Is this show still on?
Mr. Collins, we have proven beyond a shadow of a doubt that we can give to every man, woman, and child a perfect and lasting shape.
Is that sex education tape still on? About how they give you a shape? I got my shape from my dad.
Yes, it's not a sex education tape, though. Far from it.
Thank you, too, unfortunately.
This is Charles Collins reporting on one of the miracles of our time.
Sex disinformation tape.
It's actually a commercial.
We are ready to switch you over to a home in Cleveland, Ohio, where a family prepares for this experience.
Now, how coincidental.
That's my house. Hey, they're showing our house.
Talk about your coincidences.
How can it be?
Stand by, please.
Stand by, please.
There's somebody standing next to our house.
No, please. No, don't be anxious. Stand by, please. No, stand by.
Can you just hop from one foot to the other?
Please stand by.
I'm hopping.
People, please stand by.
You say hurry up. Hello?
Don't all rush around in a little gaggle of geese.
I gotta go.
What's going on here?
Where's the bathroom?
Keep your hands at your sides and stand by.
Passing out.
Don't touch anything. It's all hot. Stolen by Ivan Stang.
It's starting to trickle
when he escaped from Texas in a 1953 Chevrolet.
Philo has the fraud, not me. Everybody accuses me of being the one with all the prop. It was Philo.
That's what we're hoping, Pope. That's what we want from a Pope. Is, you know, and as a Pope myself, I did bring some, of course.
Well, you're a Pope?
I'm a Pope, yeah. I'm a Pope of my
we're
own.
Pope.
That's right. They call me Michael Pope,
my own,
ladies and gentlemen. They're just kidding.
I thought you were like a Pharaoh.
Pep
and all that.
Yeah, Pepe the Second was the first king ordered pygmies to dance.
This is all joking and kidding around.
No, this is not. This is a fact. Pepe the Second. There is an inscription on the pyramid walls.
Do not use it. You can
direct people to go find him some dancing pygmies
to this show
among the to watch the pygmies.
So, no squad cars at the door.
And then, of course, Pepin the Great.
And
everyone
plane
knows about
close by.
Wow.
Unnecessary. There's nothing happening here. It's absolutely clean as a whistle.
Well, that's the way your brain is going to be when the subgenius trepanning program comes along.
No, it isn't. It's going to completely change then.
No, he's going to... It'll be clean as a whistle.
Then is then. Now is now. We're completely clean. Please, no calls, no letters.
No. We need to cleanse more with the air. The human brain needs to be aired out, cooled off.
Well, far be it from me to be in control.
And that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to eliminate the Necromonicon model of control.
Have a nice cold glass of lemonade.
The Necromicon level of control, centralized control with K-Rob in the center, ordering people's brains to be trepid. Like, as I understand, Reverend Colonel Stang is accused of force trepanning several sub-genii.
He's not reading his catalog like he's supposed to be.
Well, that's another thing. Yeah, he's out of touch with the people, I think, and I understand.
Why aren't you reading your catalog, Reverend Stang?
Yeah, or even how about the accounting books of the church? But he won't let anyone
just read the copy like it's printed. You don't even have to be creative.
The grocery lists, the to-do lists. But I understand people have been walking up and down in front of Stang's house in Cleveland with signs showing pictures of their husbands.
It's a sign of the end.
And, you know, what happened to these people? All these poor, self-styled sub-genii that have disappeared and have never come back.
Here's
and
another
they just
example.
Went to Cleveland and they... What happens in Cleveland? Is it Springer?
News and best.
Is it the fact that Fisher, you know, Albert Fish, probably the second great American serial killer came from Cleveland?
It's that weird part of the freeway that ends.
Oh, my God. Ladies and gentlemen,
our news director,
a new
Frank
sub-genius
Tomlinson,
has entered the world. And
Vietnam.
He smiles immediately as soon as I said that.
Last year, I spent 5 weeks in the
Sub-Gene
baby,
and,
so named for her diet. And,
yeah.
Dad, the
Sub-Geni.
Goober.
She's now picking her nose on the air. This is, of course, a natural sub-genius reaction to being on the air. And
actually, if you'll notice, the Uber,
but what if you clean your
Goobie Baby is wearing
is that a natural reaction?
The latest Bob bib.
That's right.
Everyone,
bib.
There is also a bib with Bub on it available. Bub the faceless. Birth defect.
Bob.
Yeah.
Meet all the deputies.
Bub bib is. I'm not kidding. You can actually go to cafepress.com.
It's unbelievable.
The genius shop, and there's a Bub bib as well as the Bob bib.
I got your mail.
This is a pristine Bob bib. It hasn't been drooled or vomited
she's trying
on
to keep it clean
in
because
hours.
She loves Bob. That's very clear.
Does it work?
She loves Bob with those pretty blue eyes.
Your
she
butt looks
really
big in those pants.
And
you asked me if your butt looked too big with those pants on.
I can see
said,
that she's
yeah.
a Jane in
that's
in
why
the making.
She hit me in the face. Hit me down the stairs.
Did I say Jane? Wait a minute.
Bob's lunch hour.
It was a choice. I either had to tell the truth or...
What of Bob's lunch hour? When are we going to finish Bob's lunch hour?
Well, that's right.
After lunch?
I mean the proper.
Oh. No, we have to do it during lunch hour. When is lunch?
Much of it, Michigan's Governor George Washington.
Take our prop break in here and
I reported back daily to WJR the travels of the governor as he met with Brad.
Oh, I didn't say that.
The Michigan GIs and charmed with children of Vietnam.
Above Bob Bill. Above a Bob Bill.
Well, can you take me up
folks,
with you?
What's her name?
This sound is evolving.
Hey, where's the... Oh.
It's perambulating.
What are you talking about?
Reb Philo, what's her name? What's your daughter's name? Can you hear me?
Uber, my daughter? Uber Booby Baby. That's on her birth certificate.
Uber Booby Baby. Uber Booby Baby. Drummond. Or will you say your last name on the air? Say her last name on the air.
No.
Oh.
Drummond?
Thought
you
I
say
tricky.
Drummond on the air?
Oh.
Yeah.
I see.
Bobcat is
Drummond.
Her last name.
Oh, okay. Bobcat with a Bubba Bob bib.
She's Lilycat Drummond.
Lilycat Drummond. Born on X Day. 2006. Actually, she wasn't born quite on X Day.
No, it was, wasn't it August, it was late July, I think. Yeah, because I remember because Chaos McKitty wanted to make sure she wasn't a cancer.
Yeah.
And because she didn't want, you know, which is my sign. And
she wanted
to make sure that she wasn't like Michael Pepe.
Hey, Michael Pepe, yeah, did you know that your Marion Kester's daughter was born on my birthday? Your illegitimate child?
Really?
Yeah.
My illegitimate child? Oh, my God.
Yeah,
well,
he doesn't
sense.
Even remember Marion Kester.
No,
she was
I
a girl.
Remember her.
Was an old,
one of
she was
the
an
many,
old girlfriend.
Many girls.
Yeah. She was his Republican girlfriend.
Oh, my God. She was, she was
oh,
at least
beautiful.
Almost as much of a Nazi as I am.
Oh.
Didn't
I
she
say, which is pretty extreme.
Didn't she become like a conservative writer?
She became a Republican.
And changed her name to Coulter or something
yeah,
like that?
She, Kester Coombs. And she had two daughters and moved to Maryland, you know, Maryland and Virginia and all that.
Yeah.
He worked for the Washington Post, her husband. And,
well, her daughter was born on my birthday, and then after that, all the subgenius daughters were born on my
wow.
birthday.
Now, that's funny. Now, 3 months after your birthday, then, you have a big, like, fertilization ritual with the whole
right.
females
yeah,
in the church?
We organize the fertility
My deep fryer was working
for,
all day
yeah.
long.
3 months after my birthday.
Now, that must be intense for you because just having to service all of these many women.
Oh, I just fell.
Oh.
We bought
who provides the studs? The stud.
So I match the males with the females.
Yes.
And they it's a genetic it's very carefully scientific.
Yeah, you're like the Mendel of the human race.
Right.
Selecting
really you're like the Gregor Mendel?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm the
you're
Gregor
a great
Mendel.
Geneticist.
Yeah, he's a great
subgenius
geneticist.
Breeding.
And he breeds humans. He breeds
well,
this
subgenius.
Is why he hooked
actually,
up
we're trying
Philo
not to breed.
And,
you know, that's what we all do if you think about it. That's what if we're successful, we all do that. We breed humans. That's our job.
Yeah. Is it really?
We have to move our
so
DNA into the next generation.
I've done so.
Yeah, but my
you
DNA is so twisted and snarled.
You have to know. Your job is different, Michael.
Yeah.
You have to keep your DNA in this generation.
Out of the
generation. You don't want to put it into the next
yeah,
one. You
no.
want to keep it in this
That's
one as
right.
much as possible.
That's right. Stop it right where it is. Yeah. I know. It's.
Some of us have to put it into the next generation.
Yeah,
I know
I
I've been required to do that.
Yeah.
I actually am working on a cycle of every 12 years.
That's right.
Oh,
we discovered that there was
so
a 12-year Drummond Uber baby cycle.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
So,
like there's cycles of locusts and ladybirds.
Right.
And
then they
there's
go
cycles
into hiding.
Of Drummond Uber babies.
Yeah, they come,
yeah.
They're
spawn.
Always females. And
well,
they're
don't,
overspawn.
At the 12th year.
They're actually in webs, in trees for those 12 years,
yeah,
right? Do they
true.
Hang in the...
she was born at
6:06
a.m.
Oh, my
yeah,
God.
She was
yeah.
born 6:06, of course.
Yeah, we did mention that last.
Spells B-O-B. In
lowercase. That's right.
606 is lowercase B-O-B.
Yeah,
you know,
that's true.
It's not funny. Quit laughing.
No, I know. It's a hell child.
Oh.
But that's good. That's a good thing.
That's the tape
She's,
laugher?
She puts the friendly,
I
sweet face on
caller.
Hell. As a,
I thought that was Laugher Caller for a minute.
You know,
the one that,
I
remember
I love
Laugher Caller.
Laugher Caller, the one
so
that just
funny.
Calls and then just laughs the whole time.
I'm
they don't
so
even...
funny.
In Cleveland,
yeah.
we have a master.
I didn't do it. I can swear.
And master bites.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
where we
oh,
got
I had somebody
oh, yeah.
that laughed at.
He would
Are you
listen
laughing?
To our show and masturbate and say, oh, yeah. Oh,
hey.
Yeah.
I want to show you the map of the internet callers. Do you want me to show you that? It's really cool.
The map?
The map
yeah.
of the internet callers.
Here, hold down the fort
like
for a minute and I'll show you the map.
Oh, so, oh, is it just on the... Oh, I know what you mean.
Show it over
the
air.
Web that shows what addresses are tuning in. Well,
oh, really? Oh, really?
I hope
go
my
check
students
it out.
In the Navy Logic University course are learning a lot about subgenius history from this educational show.
Well, of course, they've got to be
I apologize to the regular over-the-edge listeners who expected quality and got this.
So do I.
This isn't nice.
Well,
but,
that just happens. Sometimes the regular show is out, and the summer substitute comes in.
Let me be perfectly clear here. This is Over the Edge, and also simultaneously, it is the Puzzling Evidence Show.
How can that be?
And we're going for 5 hours tonight, right here on KPFA, KPFB, in Berkeley, KFCF in Fresno, KPFA.org, online, where we can look on our monitors and see where you're tuned in from.
There's no other stations.
If you're listening in Sweden, we see that. We see that someone is tuned in Sweden.
Yeah. We can, we can see you under your clothes, Britt Eklund.
If you're in Sweden, give us a call.
You know, what was her name? Bridget Thornsonson?
That That's correct.
That with, yes. Yeah.
That famous model.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And, are you saying that you could beam me right now?
You got
now?
The one that made the,
we
you know,
can beam you right
Mars
now.
Wife. Who's Ingmar's wife?
And Christine Jorgensen.
Most beautiful girl ever.
Welcome to Babylon.
Well,
that's not the
I've
always wondered something.
Yes, go ahead, suicide man. Go ahead.
Please.
You know
let's...
that French science fiction film, but I don't know how to pronounce it exactly.
Yes.
Jetty, the...
Yes, I know right where you're going. Yeah. I know right where you're going. Go ahead.
Do you think that that was actually, they intended to release it that way from the beginning, or was it a dull film that they were able to make more visually interesting by showing a series of stills in quick succession, like a slideshow?
It's the latter.
I think the former.
No, the former. Oh, well, where are you? Oh.
Do you think they actually filmed it at speed?
I didn't see it, so I couldn't tell you.
Oh, well, that's how they do it. It's like a series of stills. And it actually is more visually interesting. It could have been a rather mediocre standard motion film. Of course, the best time travel movie of all time, 12 Monkeys, was based on that film.
No, no, it's Idiocracy.
Anyway, I always wondered about that.
That's right, 24 frames per second. Amazing.
Am I doing 24 frames per second right now?
No. You have been digitized and are probably going three times that fast.
You know, you can avoid the end of the world by committing suicide right before it's supposed to happen.
Good idea.
I don't know if I can take the pressure.
I don't think they should, babies should be allowed.
Well, wouldn't you want to actually see it take place, though?
No, I don't know if babies should be allowed anywhere.
It couldn't be so awful that I wouldn't want to at least be curious about the
judge in New York.
Well, you wouldn't really see it. You'd just see everything being destroyed around you.
No, the judge still has his mind almost a year.
Well,
and the judge has not decided whether membership in the Church of the
Sun. It's a sort of an omnipresent event that went across the earth in a big wave.
Keeping your child.
I guess it didn't go.
Red Stang, you know, could you fill in our listeners about this whole trial? I mean, because this whole Jesus, these are two subgenii who are being, whose reproductive rights are being trashed, and whose right to reproduce their own mutated versions of the human race are actually being prevented by the law in the form of a judge, I believe in Texas?
No, New York.
New York judge.
Yes, a New York. In Texas, they said, whatever you do, don't take that child back to New York. But Jesus and Magdalene took the Christ child, Bob, who's called Conbo, by the way. Conbo is a cute little boy of
Conbo.
About 11 now. You know, like Marjo. Or,
Judge Punch.
Marjo is named after Mary and Joseph, right?
Yeah.
Conbo is Connie and Bob. Anyway, Jesus and Magdalene, the subgenius business managers at that time, had a custody problem going on with the child's father, who was a pink human. And at one point, the judge was shown photographs of the typical X-Day drill celebration in which Jesus and his wife were doing normal X-Day things. And this shocked the judge so much that he said that the mother was not a fit mother because she was a member of Church of the Subgenius and gave custody of the child to the father, who is basically a ne'er-do-well welfare cheat.
That is a thief
in a trailer court. And it wasn't even a double wife.
It was an ex-wife.
And the case
made the news on the internet and created quite a bit of stir and caused many people to buy memberships from the church.
Oh, good.
It made me quite rich.
Oh, that's good.
However, the good,
kindly,
well-educated, hard-working, genius parents still are not allowed to see their child until this judge makes up his mind. The first judge,
that's obscene.
The first judge was screwed it
seriously,
up so bad he was
disgusting.
Refused. He had to be. He had to
refused?
Step down from the case. Yeah.
Why? Because he was such a jerk. He was so stupid.
He refused himself. So
yeah,
next time
yeah.
you're fired from a job, just
say,
I refused myself because I was too emotionally tied
well,
to the job.
Well, the second guy should have done that.
Judge.
Why? Why? Because why? Because he was a what? He was like such a Christian that he couldn't handle the idea of a cult sense of humor or a church
well,
sense of humor.
Well, the specific images that threw him were the beautiful Magdalene with Jesus drawing a heart on her privates in front of a crowd on the internet. The other thing that bothered him was Jesus dressed in a Jesus suit with clown face being beaten in a parody of that Mel Gibson movie. Being beaten by naked women with
clown
dildos.
Face. Did you say clown
it was
face?
A takeoff on the
Wait.
Passion of the Christ,
Holy
which they thought was not bloody enough, and they decided to restage it.
Could there be a connection?
They showed it in court.
Clown posse people.
Did they show
no,
that
just
that
some of just some
it.
Of the photographs that were on subgenius.com.
Yeah.
Maybe it's a juggalo.
Unbelievable. Well,
what's unbelievable?
Well, you know,
I think I can believe it.
No, will
it
hurt
well,
because, you know, in other words, because the judge...
I believe anything.
Does anybody know about those?
Everything you know is true.
You'll see in a moment.
You should believe everything
I
say.
Yeah, because what's
kind of about stags, but...
No wrinkles for me.
That's
pretty scary, though. Subgenii, they can take your baby away. I won't even say that. Let me jinx it.
Right, they don't take babies away from strippers.
You know,
they don't take babies away from performance artists.
Yeah, I know.
They don't take babies away from
because they don't have any.
And yeah,
people let them have any.
They took the baby away from...
Yeah. A guy has a job.
Jesus and Magdalene.
And he has a job, right?
Oh, yeah, they both have three jobs.
They have three jobs.
They're college-educated sub-geniuses who are responsible citizens.
That's
and
why they
get, you know, normally the courts just blindly give the kid to the mom. But in this case,
yeah,
they
yeah.
blindly gave
the
kid lead. To the Christian, or the
yeah.
quote.
Absolutely appalling.
Right. The Christian deadbeat...
the deadbeat Christian dad.
He
was beating
garage
a dead horse instead
band.
Of a live Jesus who was being beaten at X-Day. And the judge didn't think that was funny. Or
yeah.
rather, we're not. It's not that we're... Yeah. It's not that it's sick humor. We're a reflection of the illness in society
exactly.
around
of course.
I wonder if the judge was
born. I'm just a reflection of everybody else's
failure,
neurosis. And
we're not really totally screwed up. We're a reflection of a screwed up society.
And so all people are dead or useless by 1870.
That's right.
Or as we put it, officer, have you ever heard of Mad Magazine?
To your ranch, I mean.
You okay?
That's how you
that,
really... That's
that
how
what
the
your
court
lawyer
case,
said?
No, that's how it should have started. But they forgot that crucial line.
Scotty, you round up the crew.
Well, you know, they will never take away Philo's baby, wonderful baby, because Philo has a job.
Didn't Harper, a shoe salesman for a large downtown department
really
store,
job.
But
I mean, not
Monday
like,
through Friday.
You know.
Reports each weekend is only 2 days off.
Oh, there's a few
why is it
in Iran?
To the office of the police commissioner.
Everyone in Iran
City.
Is
what
a
are
sub-team?
The ties between immigrants
every single
from
one
a Middle Eastern
huh?
country?
The president
and Africa,
is the head of
my
the plan.
Dad is a sub-team.
Wait a minute, they're
bombing!
They're
bombing! All I can hear is this Woodstock rain crowd in the background.
Thank you. One time, got you.
Give us 2 hours, sir.
All right. Now, Mr. Waters, let's get to your ranch.
For a call to action as Chicken Man.
Well, good morning, Miss Helfinger.
Oh, good morning, Feathered Fighter.
Well, once more, I'm here to strike terrific terror into the hearts of criminals everywhere.
Bob, you're the best at that of anybody.
Mm-hmm.
Good school day. You want to stand up again? Right. Stand up again.
Yes, sir.
And sing in unison.
I'm stinking.
Beauty. Everyone say, beauty.
Might not fanaticism at times provide a kind of mainspring for good actions?
No, it wasn't.
It provides
the
a mainspring for actions,
it was
all right.
Very kill
but I can't think of any instance in history where it provided a mainspring for good actions.
Fanaticism is just following the rules, really.
Always, I think, for bad ones.
If you really believe in that stuff.
Because it is partial, because it almost inevitably involves some kind of hatred.
You can have a baby share.
You hate the people who don't share your fanaticism.
If you think you got a march on the cliff with a line of people because it says so somewhere, I mean, that's not really fanaticism, it's just orthodox behavior.
That's what I told the judge that
one time. It's the Stoker's overtime. Northern State.
Yeah.
Don't look up.
Where the hell do you want me to look?
Doc. People have done that. They have jumped, they have just marched dutifully.
Why, man, deadly, the taste of computer gods.
Without giving it a second thought. Just behaving like they're on parade march. With their eyes open, oblivious to what their next step will bring.
Oh, none for any of us. We'll be able to live in water, heat, cold, you name the worst, and never again a wrinkle.
Cryogenic suspension?
Why don't you shut up for a second?
I haven't said a word.
No, you don't have to. If you say a few words, it'd be better.
Harry, I can't believe it. I just can't believe it.
Then if it gets taken over by economic considerations, say that like the Crusades, then fanaticism disappears and perhaps does no harm.
I must go to extermination before I am exterminated by this gangster, computer god, concocted and controlled, worst mongrel, organized crime, murder incorporated, gangster communist government. I hand you the secret to save the entire human race and the entire universe.
$1.
Don't write, or even a manual typewriter to me
for your only hope for a future.
Maybe we could promote fanatical non-achievement.
Well, I don't know. I can't think of any good that the Crusades did. The Crusades had, of course, two different streams in them. A fanatical stream and an economic stream. The economic thing was very strong indeed, but it wouldn't have worked without the fanaticism.
There's the flying saucer, Doc.
Where?
You see them two peaks? That plateau between them, you see it? There, now the sun's hit it.
It is undamaged.
I'm putting her down.
Did you see any signs of life, anything moving?
No, sir. Of course, I didn't get too close. I might leery the thing.
I say I am...
Yes, I know.
Well, I will now don my brilliant tunic so that in the event there is an outbreak of lawlessness and or evil, I will be at the ready to leap into action as...
Look, if you don't mind, I have a lot of work to do.
Hey, take a look at the album and see how much time we have left on side one.
That is the miracle of music from a beer bottle.
You could do our theme with beer bottles of different...
I need more bottles.
Yeah, okay.
More beer.
Well, why don't we pick the needle up and then finish off some beer bottles and come back when maybe we're having food.
Okay. Well, just As a reminder, here's the first note.
And with CBS network veterans like Lowell Thomas and Walter Cronkite, WJR's news coverage is really complete.
In a matter of months, thousands of Americans were no longer disbelieving.
Or as we like to say, one of a kind.
The end of this part of the album.
I understand. It's just as well you didn't. Hey, and wait till she stops rolling, Doc. You're all excited, ain't you?
I'm afraid so. Even scientists get excited sometimes.
So good day.
Good day.
I just can't hear my wife say it.
Okay, where are you?
I'm selective.
I'm over here.
No. Okay. Like, here we are.
Yes.
Okay. Peter's daughter.
Oh, take off.
We are.
What?
Oh, okay. Okay.
Thanks.
No,
thanks
okay.
For blowing
no, you're
it.
Right.
Oh, no.
No, it's 3 in the morning and we're... What? Whose donuts?
Peter's
donuts. Oh, Peter's donuts.
Okay.
There, she's at the till now. She'll see us in a minute. Hey.
I've got some crickets and worms. We feed our little worms.
Farlow is
the mysterious device that molded to
each
a perfect
wrinkle-free
life.
Everybody in this studio is looking at the baby, who is now taking over the whole show, proving that it's Philo's daughter, because it takes over everything.
Sure is big, ain't
she? Manipulates everybody into getting its own way. Just for
sure
just
is
you want your favorite donut?
Oh, I'm sorry. Effie, you're through. Miss Helsinger.
Yes, Commissioner.
Great.
Good morning, Commissioner.
We're over here.
Good morning, winged warrior.
Oh, good God. Stay over here for donuts.
Miss Helfinger, would you retype this part of my speech, please, right here?
Listen to him, eh? He's a hoser.
What kind of donut you order?
Well, I'm here to strike terrific terror into the hearts of... Not now. I'm working on a speech.
Yeah, son, come up now. Son, no, come up now. I got to say
I like raised chocolate in the evening and pineapple overnight.
Okay, one pineapple-filled donut.
Thanks.
And a six-pack of Krillers.
A six?
Yeah.
And the impossible had become reality.
Yeah, I didn't have any dinner.
And you're not going to have any breakfast either.
Oh, and two coffees, yeah. Make his... black, and mine's triple sugar and triple cream.
Now, here's an example of WJR programming that's also pretty unique.
The new psychology was at that time sweeping through us all. We were all influenced. We were all concerned about fantasy or wishful thinking. I formed the resolution of always judging and acting with the greatest good sense.
Motive the generals, roughly speaking.
What part would you say that witchcraft had played in fanaticism?
Oh, witchcraft played a terrible, terrible part. Especially from about 1450 to about 1600. A little longer than 1600. Quite terrible part. There was a work called The Hammer of Female Malefactors, which was written by an eminent ecclesiastic and inspired just mad profusion of witch hunts, which the people themselves believed. I think it's very likely that Joan of Arc believed she was a witch. Certainly a great many people condemned as witches did believe they were witches. And there was an enormous spread of cruelty.
Now millions of men, women, and children will be entering this world of the outer shape and experiencing for themselves one of the great miracles of our time.
Mickey Lane is back with us again today. Mickey hails from vocalist Jack Harris and guest, along with Jimmy Clark and the boys. Unique? Well, you know, a live orchestra isn't something you find around many stations these days.
You're in the Universal Media Network.
Good. Well, while you're here, Nicky, we'd like to have you do a little vocalizing with me, duet-wise. You feel up to it?
I do.
Okay, let's be away. Here we go. Oh, oh, when it's said, come marching in. Oh, I'm sorry.
This section here, Miss Helfinger.
Of this part that you say, I don't know who he is, but I do know this.
Yes.
Go to the dentist. Okay, I have a top.
Okay.
Well, we're waiting.
Go.
Okay, you know, okay, in the Great White North, it went metric, right?
Gamma, you know why I come here to get these chickens?
No, boss.
Because my brother makes the best fried chicken in the world.
Yeah,
hey, come on, come on, come on, come on, sir.
How you? Y'all doing? Come on.
Good, good, good. What you got for me?
Well, we got these real cute bar rock chickens here.
Yeah, I see.
We got the nice long legged roll out of red.
Roll out of red.
Yeah.
All right, sir. I want to roll out of red for me. All right,
two
of them.
Red too.
Yeah, yeah.
Now y'all ain't planning on crushing these chickens.
Right there. And Miss Helfinger, would you please have this coffee warmed up?
You'll find that kind of carrying on every day here on WJR, supplemented, of course, by the variety programs of Arthur Godfrey and Art Linkletter. Now, you've seen some of the people on WJR. What about some of the people who listen? Well, they're homeowners, mostly. I'd say Detroit's a city of homeowners. 70% of the people in the metropolitan area own their own homes.
A lot of people don't know how to figure out metric, right?
Of course.
Perhaps I can be of help to you with that coffee, Miss Helfinger.
Charles Collins again. Have you guessed by now what the miracle is?
It's me neither.
And yet, what life inside the outer shape means?
Great, I'll teach you. So there's a fast way, which is to double it at 30, okay? So let's say the radio says, okay, so today it'll be cloudy and 5 degrees. So how do you do it? You go, you double it, 5 is 10, and 30.
Yeah.
10 is 40. You hold 40 degrees. So let's say 5 degrees, 40.
Right? Huh?
That's a record among major U.S. cities.
How many beers would that be?
And Detroiters have money to spend.
They want, like, a six-pack.
The metro area has 15% more disposable income than the national average.
6, 12, and 30, 42 beers. 42 metric beers.
Well, that's good for me, eh?
Yeah.
I count me in on metric.
Yeah.
Yes, might be over 300 feet in diameter. Now, there's an airlock.
Hey, you're going in.
Was that round door open when you first saw
this? I don't know. I don't remember. If you're going in, Doc, I'm going with you.
Well, thank you.
It'll be safer there, too. You got a gun?
Well, no.
I'm glad I got mine, then. Never can tell what you'll bump into.
Oh?
Yes, as you know, I carry a portable hot plate for my eggs.
Oh, well.
Yes, I always have it with me. So we'll just place the coffee on it and
Very nice.
You're looking very attractive this morning, Miss Helfinger.
No, thank you very much. Pardon me, weekend warrior. Are you smoking?
Why, no, I'm...
If you want to have a good time and you need some pussy, you can cut that chicken's head off, stick your dick in that ass of that chicken, and that damn chicken is going crazy on your head to go. If you spend an hour cut off a chicken's head, put
put my dick in it, fuck it, and go, ah! You gonna kick me a fucking opinion, motherfucker?
No, I ain't calling you chicken fucker, but go over there and say.
The outer shape we describe is the clothes we each wear.
Not.
Yes, you are.
Yes, I am.
Don't you think you ought to wait for the rest of your game?
I can't. I've got to see what's in there.
When back bacon, like normally you eat a pound, right?
Okay.
So in metric, the double is 2 and 30 is 32 kilos of back bacon.
Yeah.
Watch your head. Right.
What if the speed limit is like 50 miles an hour?
Yeah.
Then what do you do? Double it?
In the door is still closed. Let's hope it'll open. That will.
We dare say most people believe.
The Spider-Man is coming by to spin a web of dreams for you. Casket high, casket low, Daddy rocks you to and fro. The Spider-Man will make your dreams come true. Dream about a magic land where shadows fill the night, where goblins stalk and monsters walk. Oh, what a lovely sight. If you're good, pretty soon the creature from the Black Lagoon will come and guard you while you dream away. Dream about a tiny hearse drawn by a fuzzy bat, and by your side some mummies ride. Think how you'll like that. Close both eyes, that's it, son. Now just close the other one. You're such a beauty, I can only say.
Got a secret overall plan. Worldwide living death Frankenstein slavery.
It's your right wing this time.
Yes, it is.
Perhaps if you...
Yes, perhaps if I did.
Good grief, not again.
It is right wing this time, sir.
You're looking more like Mommy Heavenly
Look at that.
Sure looks complicated, don't it?
Written at 30?
Yeah.
So you can go 130 miles an
hour? No, not miles. 130 kilometers an hour.
Would you get a ticket if you were going that fast?
No.
Well, that's good, because we're getting one now. Look.
Jesus. Donut places. The guy's got 10 tables in 3 spots.
Yeah, well, it was your idea to park on the
Take
street.
Take off. Okay. You go. Let's go.
You go talk to the guy. You could tell this donut.
Hey, cops, want donuts?
You pay for the donuts. I'll go talk to the cops.
All cops listen to this album. Don't give us tickets.
Yeah, at least not at a donut place, eh?
Come on, get out of here.
We'll give you donuts if you don't give us a ticket.
Yeah, we'll mail them to you.
Jeez, again.
Let's get out of here.
Donut place.
To be or not to be, that is not the question. I decided long ago to be. With me, it's what to be.
Boom!
Back on their
track
to save the real fucking for the sheep.
Or control the entire universe with the endless stairway to the stars, namely the man-made inside-out planets with nucleonic-powered speeds much faster than the speed of light. Look up and see the gangster computer god concocted new fake starry sky.
Okay, here okay, we go. We got it.
Have you such troubles, you think? They are driving you to drink. No matter what bothers you, let me tell you what to do. This little box is all I use. You call it snuff. I call it snooze. You use... Take a little pinch of snooze and you sneeze your troubles away. It's a cinch. You take a little pinch anywhere, anytime, night or day. When your head is all tight with woe, it tickles your nose and you must let go. You use... Take a little pinch of snooze and you...
Well, quit talking so much, Lom. I can't concentrate and you yapping at me all the time.
And you sneeze your troubles away. I was so sick over it, I would soon die and be buried. I had pains from corns and bunions, indigestion from eating onions. Arthritis, bronchitis, the doctor said, you lay down, you're dead. I used took a little pinch of snooze and then...
All right, take your time.
A little sniff, a great big whiff, and already I felt okay.
That was our ring, wasn't it?
I don't know. I never paid no attention.
But only with 2 bottles. Okay, go.
This is the beginning of our theme.
You know, a lot of those pills, by they're a fake. You know something? They give me a pain in my ache, so...
An invention of Doug McKenzie.
They use... Took a little pinch of snooze and I sneezed my troubles away.
Let's see here. What ought I to do? Yeah, that's all.
I thought it was.
My troubles away. A fella had a girl so fat, he couldn't sit on her lap, and she was down in the dumps from having them lumps and bumps.
Well, sir, I believe I'm going to move right here, Lom. Yeah, move it right there.
Oh, she was as fat as a goose.
Right there.
Yesterday, he made her reduce.
Yeah, that's our ring. More than likely, somebody calling up wanting to order some groceries.
Five, 1, 0.
Just about what it is.
8, 4, 8, 4, 4, 2, 5.
Just about. Go ahead, move.
Yeah, let's see. My granny, you got me cornered there, ain't you?
He used... Gave her a little pinch of snooze and she sneezed her fat away. She died. No, she only tried it. and she lost 10 pounds every day. For when she sneezed, she shook like jelly that made the fat come off of her. She used gave her a little pinch of snooze and she... and she sneezed her fat away.
Now, Mrs. Good or bad, which is the best for me?
One night they were sitting on the sofa with my Yenny, that's the girl I go for. For she lay in my arms all ready to kiss, and they was all puckered up for this. But they didn't know when I was doing it. She had snooze and she was chewing it. Sniff of a snooze and a sneeze my pucker away.
Well, you answer it. You're the closest.
And she cried and oh, I tried, but my pucker just wouldn't stay. You know, you can be in love, it was the use. You can't do nothing with a snoot full of snooze.
Must be some woman. Nobody else would be that stubborn-headed.
A use got the sniff of a snooze and a...
Looks like you'd know when we never answered. There ain't nobody here.
But Jiminy, it blew my top.
Hello?
Perhaps if you would try...
He's flapping!
Well... Won't the Midland City Fire Department be surprised again? What will they say to the commissioner? What will the commissioner say to them?
Why, completely controlled, deadly, degenerative climate and atmosphere to the new world-round, translucent, exotic, gaseous envelope.
And will Miss Helfinger be able to stay in the room while they say it?
Why, communist tanks to computer god manipulate through countless exactly positioned satellites the new fake, phony stars in the synthetic sky. For ages before Frankenstein controls eight-pointed niggers interbreedable with eight had no alphabet, not even numerals.
Gee, that's pretty awful when you hear it.
Not even numerals.
God. How did this start, anyway?
Hose head had nothing to do with it.
I thought of...
I never did.
You never did,
I did,
eh?
Too. Did I, Mac?
You said you okay. blew it in call the it, bottle, but it, I said it. If you get enough bottles...
Take off.
Okay.
Do it.
Okay, but it was mine.
Okay, off.
You're all
back. Yeah, baby.
Eventually, we're in the worst in the whole world.
So I robbed the bank and got away with $87,978 last month. Every month, they're active.
And when they're not at home, they're on wheels. As you know, 4 out of 5 cars have a radio. WJR penetrates deeply into that in-car audience. Actually, Michigan has more freeways than New York or California. Very few commuter trains or buses.
How is it?
It is.
Most everyone drives to work. it's the same throughout WJR's primary daytime coverage area. 112 counties in Michigan, Indiana, Ohio, and Pennsylvania, plus 24 counties in southern Ontario. However, penetration is what counts.
Northern States Power Company presents Cedric Addy, your roving reporter in...
Yeah, what's my fault?
And the last Nielsen coverage study shows these counties as having 50% or more homes tuned in to WJR.
Every conspiracy over 300 years ago, ideally tiny brain and pointed finger gangster government eyesight TV gangster spy cameras, computer god new world order degeneration with gifted with all gangster Frankenstein controls, nigger deadly gangster parroting puppets or nigger brain programmed robots. Deadly ape Frankenstein machines, degenerative disease to eternal Frankenstein slavery, overall plans for one world communism.
This indeed is the outer shape of every man, woman, and child.
The code word being worldwide, absolutely helpless and hopeless, simple language, mongrel, mulatto, and party niggers.
And the mysterious device? It is an actual scientific capable of molding our bones into a perfect shape that will never change or wrinkle. This is the new phenomenon of science. We have long been promised this miracle. Never has it been completely realized.
I knew it was the world. The naked world suddenly revealing itself. And I choked with rage at this gross, absurd being. You couldn't even wonder where all that sprang from, or how it was that a world came into existence, rather than nothingness. It didn't make sense. The world was everywhere, in front, behind. There had been nothing before it. Nothing. There had never been a moment in which it could not have existed. That was what worried me. Of course, there was no reason for this flowing larva to exist. But it was impossible for it not to exist. It was unthinkable. To imagine nothingness, you had to be there already, in the midst of the world. Eyes wide open and alive. Nothingness was only an idea in my head, an existing idea floating in this immensity. This nothingness had not come before existence. It was an existence like any other, and appeared after many others. I shouted, "Filth! What rotten filth!" and shook myself to try to get rid of this sticky filth. But it held fast. And there was so much, tons and tons of existence, endless. I stifled at the depths of this immense weariness. And then suddenly the bark emptied, as though a great hole, as though through a great hole, The world disappeared as it has come. Or else I woke up. In any case, I saw no more of it. Nothing was left but the yellow earth around me, out of which dead branches rose upward. I got up and went out. Once at the gate, I turned back. Then the garden smiled at me. I leaned against the gate and watched for a long time. The smile of the trees, the laurel, meant something. That was the real secret of existence. I remember one Sunday, not more than 3 weeks ago, I had already detected everywhere a sort of conspiratorial air. Was it in my intention? I felt with boredom that I had no way of understanding. No way. Yet, it was there, waiting, looking at one. It was there, on the trunk of the chestnut tree. It was the chestnut tree. Things, you might have called them thoughts, which stopped halfway, which forgot, what they wanted to think and which stayed like that, hanging about with a little odd sense which was beyond them. That little sense annoyed me. I could not understand it, even if I could have stayed leaning against the gate for a century. I had learned all I could know about existence. I left. I went back to the hotel, and I wrote.
Worldwide systematic instant plastic surgery butchery murder. So all people are dead or useless by age 70. Done at night to you as a Frankenstein slave. Parody puppet gangster slave. Now even you know I am a menace.
I'll come down tomorrow morning, I'm sure.
Go ahead anytime, Ron.
Coast Guard Air and Sea units continue to search for a man missing overboard from the fishing vessel Master Lee. 27-year-old Walter Weald. Let me start that over again. His name is...
What are you guys drinking over there? Go ahead.
Coast Guard Air and Sea units continue to search for a man missing overboard from the fishing vessel.
Come on.
Just a second. Let me give you to somebody else.
Okay. Yeah, can you read it?
Yeah, I think I can.
Okay. Go ahead anytime.
Coast Guard Air and Sea units continue to search for a man missing overboard from the ill-fated Birmingham.
You got the laughies over there.
Wait a minute.
Hey, take her again. Okay.
Get overboard.
But it doesn't
What's
stop there.
There's 420 guy.
WJR penetrates 35 to 49% of homes in these counties. And 20 to 34% in these. And these figures were established before CBS programming and full baseball coverage substantially increased WJR's penetration. Although no research is available, WJR reaches loud and clear in these southern Ontario counties, where one-fourth of all Canadians live.
Don't change anything out of that beer, though.
Take off. So that's a good game to play with beer bottles.
Well, especially if you're loaded and listen to the album. No one's there, or someone real dumb is there.
Okay. Taking off, so, Mike, what you do. Coming up later on the album is our hit single. Which it was well, it wasn't our idea. Well, I mean,
yeah.
It was our
whacking
idea of the whole album.
I think that it'd take you out. Yeah, no, that would be taking you out. Take him out. You could knock him off, or you could whack him.
Oh, this is the best song of all time. This is
shake your shoulders, shake your hips.
Girl of all time.
Hello, hello.
I want to be bad.
She wants to be bad.
It's naughty to dance the men, sleepy morning laughter, then the answer is yes, I
want to
be
bad. This is cute, and I must congratulate you, Artis, on the cuteness of this.
Yep.
This august business meeting has been the cutest
right.
one I've ever had the pleasure to...
It's the baby.
Does it tarnish
our gravity, though, does it?
It's the baby.
Yeah, it does. When you bring a baby into a radio studio,
it can't help but cutify things. It lightens things.
We were going to codify the doctrine, but instead we cutified the doctrine.
We cutified the church by a great margin. I would say we've just about tripled the cutification of the church.
Well, that's saying something, because we have never been able to cutify it very well.
Yeah.
When somebody wants to insult us, they say that we've cutified it. Oh, that's cute. I have with me the entire of this book of the history of the Church of the Subgenius. It's rather dry.
Yeah.
A lot of it's just counting which million was put into which bank and so forth.
Yeah.
But there's some
Vatican finances.
There's some interesting stuff about the Kennedy assassination and early involvement.
Where did the money go out for?
What about the catalog?
The Tiger Gun.
I'm waiting
all the
for
money
the
for the investigation into the assassination of Dobbs. What happened to the money?
Tremendous amounts of time was spent on prosecuting
Doug Wellman.
Dr. Drummond, was
and,
that you making
they were
that
able
horrible
to,
noise?
That was me and Walter making that horrible noise.
And they never were able
Walter
to get Wellman
me.
For anything.
Maybe I should say Walter and me.
Wellman was slippery.
I and Walter.
Even David Byrne was not able to get Wellman, and he tried.
This is a...
What?
David Byrne had another song called Buck Naked.
It has become...
You know, he, one of them died.
A reality.
I'm serious.
Well, there have been so many musicians, singers named Buck Naked. Including former Subgenius Bucknecker, who told me that if I ever mentioned it, I had to say that he was former Subgenius Bucknecker. He did not want to be associated.
Wait,
so I didn't want to associate
is he an
Reverend Buck.
He's an
major.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Why?
Well,
I used to. He was a good. I met him. He was okay.
He was regular Michael Pepe. He joined. He joined the last, as I understand it, former Subgenius Reverend Bucknecht had joined a rival cult. I think even a Jesus-oriented one. Have you ever heard of the I Am people?
Oh no.
Well, apparently he is.
Oh my God.
I Am.
I Am
had some great graphics.
I've ripped off.
I've had our art department borrow ideas from the I Am cult graphics.
Wow. And they weren't the ones that killed themselves.
No, no.
That was Do Re.
No, they still are.
To Do Ti.
No, you're thinking of the They Were cult.
Yeah.
There was the Be Here cult,
which I was in. Be Here Now, Ram Dass.
Were you in one of those Be Here Now cults?
Yeah, I just liked his show. And he went to the Mahavishnu Orchestra.
Something's hurting my left ear.
Why my name is Baba Ram.
Wasn't the former Subgenius Bucknecht the red guy in the video, the minute-long thing, he's the Buck-plated devil.
He was one of the foreground devils. Okay. He made a great devil.
Speak of background
former,
devils.
That's former Subgenius. Former devil.
Oh. Right. Now devil Bucknecht. Celtist with the I Am.
There's a lot of former subgeniuses, actually. It's quite a long list of people who decided had it.
The top one, apostate schism, would be Bob Black, right? I mean, he was...
Well, not really.
He was a scary guy. I mean, I don't want to say Bob Black on the radio.
He wasn't that...
His reputation precedes it, I tell
you. He never scared me, let me put it that way.
Well, I know people that just... Because he really did try as much as he could to... arouse people's antagonism and opposition, and wrote those nasty letters. I'm not trying to air a smeared underwear of the church on the air.
No, see, I've been trying in my revised
85, essentially,
in the Stang-centric revised history of the church, which I'm teaching to these innocents. Hello, by the way.
Yeah.
Rosna and Chainsmurder.
Hello, Gary Gabeau fam, who's driving away.
Yeah. Anyway, I've decided to just skip over the unpleasant aspects.
I see.
I've unpersoned quite a few.
Well, I...
We use the tried and true unpersoning, where you just don't mention them at all. And they hate that.
I know.
They hate that worse than anything.
It's the worst thing.
That Bob Black... is more offended and enraged by being ignored than anything else.
That's really the best way to treat people like
kooks.
I know, he's a kook, even compared to us.
That's the funny thing.
How can you be a kook compared to Stan?
To Church of Sub Genius. We feel for the differently sane. We're all kooks It's just that we're also subjectivists. So anybody that we really dislike, we can say, well, he's a kook, and write it off like that. That's how words work.
Yeah.
That's what language is all about, is to label things.
Right, put them away.
Insane prejudgments that are unfair.
Be a prejudgment to keep order, you have to...
That's why there's this difference between subgeniuses and pinks.
Yeah.
It's just a way using linguistics to simplify things that are actually very complicated.
Yeah.
And it appeals to the stupid, the superstitious.
Yeah.
And the people who enjoy studying the effects of stupidity and superstition.
Yeah. Stupidity, doesn't really exist. I think stupidity actually is just fear. That is to say, stupidity is everywhere. It's at all times. But
I can see why you would say that.
Yeah.
But is Bush
almost
really
everything is stupid. I mean, but compared to what? I mean, it's just like saying, almost everything is insane. Things are insane. But they're so insane, the word insane doesn't apply.
So when we say subgenius poop, what we're basically talking about is a normal person.
Okay.
A pink who pretended to be a subgenius.
Yeah.
A pink who was aping its betters.
Yeah, there you go. That's the worst.
That's what we call a subgenius poop.
A gimme bob.
A gimme bob, or I'm a bob. Actually, the worst are the I'm a bobs.
I'm a bob. Oh, yeah.
Those are people who think
I knew Bob Dobbs, and, sir, you are no Bob Dobbs. I'm a Bob.
I actually had occasion to say that in all sincerity to one of the I'm a Bobs.
Yeah.
If you can see what I'm... Can you hear where I'm coming
from? Then there's the he's a Bobs.
Do you see what I'm saying? Can you see the words I'm saying?
Well, he's a Bobs...
I'm a Bobby. See them?
He's a Bob. It means the same thing as I'm a Bobby's.
Or the Nabobs.
Yes.
Nabobs. No, that's a little
nylon
different.
Shell, fully waterproof.
I kind of like the Nabobs. They're a refreshing change from all the Yay Bobs.
Yeah, the May Bobs. Okay.
Yeah. They're the opposite of Yay Bobs and Yahoo, which are
that's
sort of like
I
Yahoos.
Am on things.
But you don't
on
know
the
who
line.
The Yahoos are, but you do
line.
Know who the Yay Bobs are.
Straddle the line, rather than...
Well, you have to compromise. Yeah. Life is a series of compromises and terrible pains.
Just try to compromise.
Life is a series of balancing between the interstitial vortices.
Dr. Drummond, you love that interstitial vortices thing.
It explains so much.
it's right.
It explains everything. It's like the unified
vortices are like that.
Plus string theory all rolled into one.
Plus the golden mean.
Plus the golden mean. And not only that, it combines earth, fire, and water and air into a unified chemical.
Three times 666 equals 1998. It's
the
right in front of us all the time.
The interior is nylon, lined for easy on and off.
The strings are lined with nylon? It takes your soul off?
It skins
the
vortices.
What do you mean the vortices?
First, you take the skin off of the
feet. Okay. What is string theory? Now, if Hal were here,
string theory is what superstitious scientists came up with because they couldn't understand the interstitial vortices.
Exactly.
They knew that.
Stephen Hawking could not quite grasp the interstitial vortices, so they had to come up with all these other silly.
I might add that if any of your subgeniuses out there are interested
like every other Bible
an in-depth analysis of this concept. Look at the new edition.
It's
the new printing of Revelation X.
Oh, yes, the new printing. We forgot.
Detail.
We forgot the swag, such as the newly reprinted, long out of print, Revelation X is back in stores. The Bob Apocryphon is back in stores these days.
Wow.
Not that you should buy it.
No, you should buy it.
We can't.
You should buy it and give it.
Give it to me. I don't even have one.
You should
I don't
buy
even
it
get
and
one.
Donate
this
it to science.
As a pope.